34.
34. Thank you, Evan. A.M. We'll call to order. We have a quorum. We have all members present. Nobody participating remotely and no guests. Okay. So we have no information back from the town attorney. That's
no surprise there.
So it's no update.
So there's no update.
I'm just going to send you the template. I thought I had it for today.
And also, I used Phyllis's decision tree too, but it's we're using three, and then 3.11. Is that what we're using as a reference for our decision tree? I guess we should decide on exactly how we want to continue to address our decision, our public our practice.
Mm-hmm.
So, just to really screw with things, since we're busily sending agendas to each other, I just wrote two things on the agenda that
yes.
I meant to save as my. Are you guys seeing that?
Yes, we're
good.
Seeing
now
it.
I will happened? Save my
I'm
own
sure
copy.
I don't see that.
Because I wrote 9:34 and I wrote no update.
Okay.
So I am going
to
go ahead and save my own copy now so that you guys don't have to see that.
Okay.
Have the agenda.
Let me.
Find what I
well, I don't want to mess up everybody else's notes of their own either.
Thanks.
Okay, so.
So, Sarah's question
how
would what
we
is.
Like to, as a committee, refer to the practice that we voted to adopt?
Meaning what the name of it
what?
Is?
Yeah.
I did find the one that I just.
George, did you have it as like, I had copied it this way, it was three, and then another, I think, 3.11?
Mm-hmm. What I have is it, you're right.
It is in another document described.
It's under process and decision trees. And if it's the right one, it's process 3-11. It's a PDF, and it's. The most recent modifier was Evan, which would be correct, I think.
All right, so it's just there's no three before it. I just.
I don't see it. I'm going to open it.
11.
I'm going to open it and see what we have.
Okay.
This does look like the yes, the draft that we. Better one needs to look at it and make sure we're looking at the right thing.
So we're in the process and decision trees
right.
folder.
That's correct.
And POCA proposed process 311.
That's correct. That's the one that I understand to be the one that we decided on. But I need that.
That seems
to be
like the most recent document.
Yeah.
Yep.
Other than what's the report? What's this one?
Report it's town council thing. Appointments. I don't know. This looks
that was
like
the multiple member bodies, option one, option two, option three.
Right. That was.
That's okay. Also sitting there. Right, because why wouldn't you sit there?
I'm sorry, you're sending this to her. What are we talking about?
So that's what
we're just trying
to
agree as
out.
To the name and the actual file that we have decided to be the process.
And I just sent you
and
the
in the process and decision trees folder, the unique one, right, if you're there, under, it's down in the bottom. OCA proposed process 3-11 PDF. It's my understanding that is what we used, and that's what I referenced, I thought, in the minutes. But you need to look at it and make sure that's right.
That's correct.
And
that's the most updated.
Right. And it's the one that we agreed to follow, given the fact that we don't have definitive legal guidance, and we're probably not going to get it anytime soon.
Right.
So I think we need to just go ahead.
So
and didn't we already vote on it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we're just trying to.
So could some, and I'm sorry to ask you to catch me up, but I'll try not to do this very much. But in terms of documents that are in this folder that are of recent vintage, I'm looking at this one, which is the one, the 311 one, right,
mm-hmm.
that everybody's talking about,
right?
Yes,
right.
For the camera. And But there's also a document that I seem to have moved into there that's the potential options to multiple member bodies that includes several decision trees. Is mm-hmm. this out of date, or is this the currently expanded version of the words on this page?
I think I put that in there only because I put that in there just to see past decision trees, because what I wanted to get at was what a completely public process looks like.
What's
and I will explain to you
this
the
one's
evidence
from a couple
that
weeks
actually
ago.
Do that for us, and we should have it by our meeting tonight, right?
I've already done the schematic. If you want
yeah.
the narrative, I can write a narrative.
If you could, then
for
but we talked
tonight.
So, I mean, if you, but it actually doesn't need to really be done. The narrative doesn't really need to be done today. It only needs to be done by our next town council meeting.
Potentially.
And I'll explain why. Yes.
So the thing that's called report-TC appointments to MMB process trees
yes.
is undated. That is what is confusing me. But it is where we ended up in terms of schematics prior
yes.
to the revisions that
this
you are making. So it is our most recent version. Is that correct? Is this our most recent version of process trees in addition when coupled with the OCA proposed process?
Yes. This was before we got this is my mistake because I should have dated it. But this was before we got legal opinion from town attorney about the dyads.
Okay.
And this was when we were awaiting that decision. And so the third diagram in that is our proposed process. And the other two were, here are two options we could do if town attorney tells us we can't do the dyads, which she did.
Okay. And so then if the one that we are actually working on, 311,
mm-hmm.
the nice pretty tree that's on that one, that's the one we're currently working.
That is the one that we voted.
Okay,
last
so this other is just background.
And where
it's
is
previous
the one
decision
that
making.
Has the public process?
So technically there's an example of that in the report town council appointments. Sarah asked last night
right.
via an email
right.
I received. I started working on that, but given that I got that email at like 10 p.m.
But it's going to be on that document?
I will add it to the SharePoint when I have completed it, which will be sometime today.
As a separate document?
That's a separate document, correct.
Okay, cool.
So,
so a completely public process we don't have in this.
But we will have.
I mean, we've talked about
and
it.
And basically, yeah, we will need, I think we should sort of talk about it right now.
Because none of these three options on this document were completely public. They were just variations of what we were trying to do with privacy.
Right. So
correct.
So that everybody's on the same page, Darcy has submitted a minority report, sort of as encouraged or suggested or given information
suggested.
By Lynn that at our last meeting when we took the vote that we should also have a minority report. I would just like us to have by next town council, not tonight's town council meeting, but the meeting after, we need to sort of talk about how we would like to put together a SharePoint and a presentation of our decision tree, our practice that we voted on and adopted our last open meeting, and somewhat of a summary of how we got there and what an alternative practice would look like. Tonight, after I present our report, then Lynn will ask Darcy to present her minority report. Darcy has already told us previously that she feels strongly about the fact that our practice should be voted on and adopted by the full town council. Lynn has said that after Darcy makes that request, that Lynn will then respectfully put that discussion and vote for our next town council agenda. expect that this evening, and also because time is short, I would like to be able to sort of start getting together how we would like to present that at our next, not tonight's, but our next town council meeting.
I think that we also should realize that we're not, the point is not that I'm objecting to this particular process.
Right.
It's just the principle of
bringing
a policy decision to
right.
the town council.
Right.
So it's not really about one or the other process, but.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
I'm a little bit confused about what the process for tonight is. Lynn is planning to make a motion.
No. Darcy will make her report.
We'll make the report, correct.
Can I back up for a minute?
Very briefly.
Why is Darcy making a minority report? Did you actually say we voted to have a minority report? Since when do you vote to have minority reports?
No, Lynn just suggested it at
okay.
the last meeting.
So at everybody I've ever been part of, when you have a report, you say, this many people voted for it, this many people voted against it, and you write why people voted for it and why people voted against it. You don't have a separate piece of paper that's called a minority report. It's not what we did at town meeting. And if people wanted to then question what the, like more, like they felt like maybe the planning board, because this is the best example that we used in this community, gave short shrift to what the minority opinion was, like they wrote this much and then only that much, then somebody in town meeting would say, I want to hear more from the three people who voted against this because I feel like I don't have enough information based on what you wrote in this report. I think maybe you're not telling the whole story. And then that person would report. I'm not sure, I don't have any understanding as to why we would have an official separate, you will automatically be called on to do a minority report sort of deal. I just, that makes no sense to me. So if I don't like something that I'm a committee member of, I just get to automatically be recognized for a minority, I do not understand that process
mm-hmm.
at all. It might work, I mean, I want to give you the chance to talk, Darcy. I just want it to come from a counselor saying, I'd like to hear more, or I think it's perfectly laid out here, and Darcy is absolutely right, and I'm going to agree with her, as opposed to, why do you get as much airtime as the majority opinion? I don't understand that. I don't get it. And it's not you personally. It's just, this is a new process thing for
yes.
us, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
For the council, because we
yeah.
knew it was going to start getting harder.
Yeah, we did it sort of with the ECAC ad hoc committee report, but not really. It was all in one report. It was all in one report.
Mm-hmm.
And this, Lynn asked to have it addended as an addendum to the
So that's fine. She can have an opinion. That doesn't make it the law.
Right. So, well, that's something we can talk
Rules
about.
Probably
at the,
needs to
yeah.
I was going to say, I think, because that was, so I, Lynn, this came because of Lynn, and when the moment that left Lynn's mouth, I thought, what? Because it does make me nervous. Because so in GOL, we had a 4-1 vote. I was the one who dissented. I have no intention of writing my own GOL report to explain my one dissenting vote, and it seems problematic if every time there's a split vote, someone gets a minority report, and then they get to present it to town council. Not just because it's messy, but also it's time consuming. So I think this is something that Rules needs to figure out a way. Or, I hate to do this, it could be a GOL thing because it has to do with anything that's not rules is GOL.
Needs
yeah.
to fix it
but
later,
there needs to be some standardization of reports too, because it did strike me that every split vote should not have a separate minority report.
It should be covered in the report.
Right.
I mean, you
report,
absolutely you can't
right.
ignore what the other people said and remember.
And this
of course,
was and this was you know this is not this is Lynn. Lynn said this and
remembering, of course, there could be multiple people with multiple reasons.
Mm-hmm.
So they shouldn't all have to write separate reports
yeah, so
on what their minority
so when
opinion
I wrote
was.
My report, I feel like it was sort of, I know I haven't actually written a report to put out. We have two. So I needed to do that. I did not cover, I sent you a draft, which I know that Alyssa has suggested some edits. So I'll change that. And just to be really clear, so that I'm totally clear about what's happening. So at our meeting, our last meeting, we had a vote that was not unanimous. Lynn had said to Darcy, you should write a minority report and submit. Darcy did write a minority report, but she did submit. I had an email from Lynn this morning asking me please to attach that to my report. And then I was also, Darcy was kind enough to CC me in on Lynn's response to how, Darcy asked, how should I make this motion, you know, about what I'm concerned about.
I'm confused about what this motion, this is a formal, is there a formal motion?
No, it's just a report.
I'm actually just gonna read to you, this is what I pulled up and then I tapped my screen and it went away.
Okay.
Okay, this is what Lynn has proposed as a process. She said, I have asked Sarah to include the minorities report with her report she will be providing us early this afternoon. It will be added electronically to the material for tonight, and I will ask Margaret to make a copy for our folders. When Sarah gives the report, I will call on you, Darcy, to briefly give your minority report. At that time, you can request that we take up the practice as a discussion and vote at our next meeting. Clearly, I will honor that and place it on the agenda.
So I'm just gonna say that I think both of those last two aspects are poor meeting management. That's not the way to run things. So I think it's fine to have some thoughts about how the minority report should be incorporated. I think personally I prefer incorporating it rather than leaving it separate because I think everybody in OCA's opinion should be covered in the OCA report. And so I know Lynn gave the suggestion and I know nobody wants to piss off the president, but obviously I'm gonna go ahead and do it. And so is that you include everybody's opinion in there. And a good chair would make, who could be the minority opinion on any given topic,
right,
would also include, would make sure that the minority opinions, because there might be more than one, that get reflected, you know, accurately reflect. Like, you shouldn't just, and shouldn't, you know, she didn't like it. You should say, like, actual words, right, and
right,
why.
Right.
That's totally reasonable.
Yeah.
And that should be in the OCA report. The OCA report should be presented by the chair. Then the president should ask if there are any questions. And if other town councilors, and arguably I suppose, which could include the president, because she doesn't lose her status as a town councilor, don't understand or don't feel like they got enough information from the OCA report about the minority report, just like they can ask Sarah questions, because I'm sure they're gonna ask questions about the main report, they can ask questions about Darcy's minority report, and then the president can recognize Darcy. But the idea that she would, I think perhaps she's thinking more in terms of being clear that she's respecting the minority opinion rather
right.
than that she's thinking through
right.
the practicality of trying
right.
to do it the
right.
way she's talking about. Because then somebody says, well, I'd love to hear more from the minority opinion, and then turns to you and says, well, you're that one, right? Or there's not like three people that voted against it, okay, for various reasons. Then that's the minority report, okay, fine. Then the question is, what happens next? It's insane that you would give a minority report and then make a motion. Those two things don't have anything to do with each other. And so if there's a motion or a suggestion, either way, to be made before the discussion is over, as opposed to, well, thank you so much for your report, OCA. We've all heard what you said, and there's no action needed, right? Because we're not actually recommending in this report an action at this point by the council. It's just an update. So she says, okay, then I guess we'll turn to another committee. And then it might make total sense, Darcy, to say, actually, I'm not done. thanks, everybody heard the OCA report. But given that, just like Pat could say that, Pat, who's not seen any of this until this afternoon, could say, well, wait a minute, OCA, what you doing?
That's insane.
I wanna have another discussion about this.
Right.
And so, then she could say that whichever counselor, which could be you, Darcy, if somebody isn't beaten to it, says, I want to do X, I want to have another discussion, or I move to refer something, or it could be, you know, whichever. It doesn't have to be like a formal motion necessarily. And then I would think, based on my experiences as chair, that you would set, as president, you would say, okay, is that a motion or is that a thought? What, how's everybody think about that? And everybody might go, yeah, sounds good. Or everybody might go, what? And then they say, okay, well, let's have a vote. Do we need to discuss this further as a council, or do you want to send it back to OCA to think about some more? You know, what's your pleasure, council? And then the council's like, oh, well. And then Darcy says again, I feel really strongly about this. And Pat and Alyssa's like, nah. And then we have a vote or not, and it works out. But like, it's not up to Lynn to decide that we're going to have this as a future agenda item if the whole council doesn't want it as an agenda item. Like, she has to manage the agenda from the standpoint of course, she has to do a whole bunch of stuff in a certain period of time because it's, whether it's a resolution for a certain date or a parking request or a budget forum that has to be done at a certain time. Like, she has to manage all that without, like, asking us if we think it's important to meet deadlines. I get that.
Okay, so what do we need to do
today
now about this?
Is it makes sense to me, right? What makes sense in light of all of that?
Right now,
to get us through tonight.
Sarah's report does go over the rationale for the majority's opinions on each of those things. And then at the end on the same document is a separate little two paragraphs of my, you know, at the end of the section about that vote, I have one sentence. The minority report on this vote is at the bottom of this document. And then it's at the bottom of the document. It's like two paragraphs. So
can we just move it up?
I don't want to treat it separately. Should I include it just like I would have done had there not been a separate minority report? Should I just write mine the way that it would normally be written?
I mean, I would, what's normal in this reality? But yeah. I would argue that normal would be reflecting the substance of the conversations, right? Just like it's not a transcript, just like minutes. It's reflecting the different concerns people have. And so it would reflect the majority opinion, and it would also reflect, just like, you know, Evan's particularly concerned about a thing, I'm concerned about a thing, George is concerned about a thing. And then you just go ahead and say, here's the minority report right in there before you move into the next topic.
Yeah.
Because that feels more inclusive to me if that was part of our conversation.
I think that it works out all right for us to do that now because we've had this conversation and this is the day of the actual meeting. But practically speaking, in the future, it's hard because a lot of these reports get in at the very last minute. Mm-hmm. And as far as, you know, juggling these different things, it might be difficult. But anyway, we don't have to solve that right here. So. Why don't we just decide what we're doing with this? Because I know we have a bunch of other things to decide today.
So I think, you're I'm looking at your report right now. It's a paragraph, right? So it seems like that paragraph could just be worked in. If you're, I mean, I sort of feel bad because you wrote something and we don't want to get rid of what you wrote, but it seems like it could just be worked into the current report.
It doesn't
like,
matter
literally
to me.
Your language could be copy
it's,
and paste.
It's fine
yeah,
with
it's copy
me.
Paste.
The principle is that I would like to maintain the ability of people to write minority reports, but I don't care about this one in particular because we're all here and we're talking about it, and that's fine.
Okay. And I think as far as I agree that it's been a problem that reports tend to get written and submitted so late. Although I do think that part of that is a product of the fact that this committee meets every week. So like GOL, because we meet every other week, we see a draft of the committee. The chair of GOL sends a draft of the committee report to the entire committee for feedback editing a week before it's submitted. Because we meet twice a month, right? So we meet on a Wednesday, we get the report the following Wednesday at the latest, and then there's a week for the entire committee to sort of add things before it has to go in the following Wednesday. It's tough for this committee because we meet every week and that's a lot. So one of the things we might want to consider is maybe this committee adopts an idea of we don't submit a report to the council every council meeting, you
and
know,
I
that,
haven't.
And you haven't,
I
and
haven't. And
I
tried
think that's
to do this time simply because of minority.
It's important, right?
Going out. We had made a lot of votes,
right?
So what I tried to do is I did send you my draft, and I realized it was last night. It wasn't.
Right, I haven't, to be honest,
before,
I haven't
right? Yet. Just and the only thing that I had put in were a couple votes that I wanted to be able to take today, and I still can send that to everybody ahead of time. And maybe what we want to agree on is, unless it's something special, when I'll send you guys a report, like say the report out every 2 weeks or once a month, I will send it out to you as quickly in advance as I can, trying to give you at least 48 hours. And then normally I probably would not report out on something we had doing at a meeting that morning.
Definitely.
I think this is just a somewhat different circumstance because we were also asked at our last meeting to consider taking two things out of our charge, which I know from being on the Lynn's goal committee that that's something that she really wants us to report back on because it's timely for it to be discussed and decided. So that's.
So I'm lost. What happened to your report? Why is it look? I don't want to make anybody panic here, but it's coming up as a blank document.
Okay, if it's a template, it is blank. So if you're looking at a template, you're okay.
I've got two things called template.
Okay, there should be a draft. There should be one that says.
What folder would I be looking in for this? It's not yet under reports to
template.
It's
in our meeting agenda.
It's in the meeting.
It's in our meeting
packet. I mean,
our meeting packet. Yeah.
Okay,
yes.
So it's in the meeting packet for today.
Yeah, it's there.
Okay, so I was looking under reports to town council,
okay,
but it hasn't made it that far yet.
So now I have not been able to, I haven't looked at Darcy's edits.
So this is the thing called draft town council standing committee.
Yeah.
I don't know why this thing won't wrap instead of cutting things off. Okay, so I could take, so some of this, as I understand it, everybody's editing this document, this is awesome. Some of this is the idea that we're kind of pre-writing, just like you pre-write minutes,
mm-hmm.
right? Like Lauren suggested, you pre-write minutes. You know what's going to happen anyway.
I could do that.
And so just tell us what we're supposed to have said. And so I'm just looking for the right space to paste this in. So the motion carried 3-1 with one wait, which one is this? Which one do I paste it under?
Also, Darcy, did you take out the part that I had written
this one.
Yep. About, I mean, maybe just not finding it, about the things that.
Or actually, hold
one, on. 3 or 3-1?
I don't think
that's
I took anything
figured.
Out.
Pause.
Then it's got to be something else.
It's actually it's the 1-3-1. Yeah, failed 1-3. It'd be that one. Because that's the motion she's referencing in her report.
Two, right.
Was that one, was to bring it to the council. So, all right, so it sounds like we're moving that into this. Alyssa's doing it now. So my second question, based on what Lynn said, is it sounds like the way Lynn wants to run this, you're gonna talk, then Darcy will talk. Although to me, it actually would be more appropriate, and maybe we should say this to Lynn, for you to give the report, and then you could say, I'd like to hand over. It seems like it doesn't make sense for Lynn to recognize you than Darcy. It seems more, to make more sense for Lynn to recognize you, you give your part, and then you to recognize
yeah,
Darcy.
Fine.
Darcy should still speak, but it should be
that's
she
fine,
should be recognized
fine.
By you. It sounds to me from the email, Lynn also is leaving open the possibility, if Darcy so chooses, to make a motion that the council discusses and votes on the process.
I don't even know if it requires a motion, does it? I mean, Lynn
well,
can just say,
she could.
Let's put this on the next agenda for the next
But
meeting.
She should only do that if the rest
right.
of the council thinks it's a good idea
that
to
would
put
be,
it on.
That would be
It's not just
to
her
us.
To decide, oh sure, every single time Alyssa thinks of something, she should get it put on the agenda. Like,
right.
Yeah, I don't really yeah, think it works that
really
way.
I don't really understand how that works. But,
right.
Yes.
But I want to enable you, if you want, assuming you or Pat or whoever wants to make that suggestion, whether it be in the form of a motion or if it, however you want to do it. I mean, again, since we don't have a rule, who knows what we're doing? is that, but that not be done as part of your report. So Sarah speaks, Sarah says, I'm going to turn it over to Darcy because she can explain what she wrote and you can ask her any questions. And again, I would argue that that wouldn't normally need to be done except for the fact that this report is coming out in real time. If people had, you know, from Wednesday to read. But of course, we didn't have any of the town council material on Wednesday because that Wednesday deadline thing fell apart for the entire town, not just for us.
Mm-hmm.
And so we, and so then after everybody kind of digests, because people will probably ask questions then. And then it would be appropriate before Lynn moves on to the next thing to have a note to herself. Before I move on to the finance committee report, I should look to Darcy because I think Darcy wants to make a separate statement.
Correct.
About what we're getting, what we should, she suggests we do as a council next time.
Right. So Lynn could do it unilaterally, but it would be inappropriate for her to do so. It would feel like it's undermining the actions of this committee. So I think it's really up to you about whether or not you want to bring forth the discussion, which I think should take the form of a motion if we're gonna decide to do that, about whether to force this committee to present the process and the council to vote to adopt the process at its April 22nd meeting. So my question for you is, do you intend to make that motion?
I hadn't because it didn't look like I needed to, but I can. Yeah. I don't think we need to decide that here.
I would like to know if
I think your fellow, if it's okay if you don't know the answer yet, but I think as your colleagues, we need to not be surprised if you know for sure that you're going to do something.
Right.
But if you're still thinking about something, then you could just say, you know, I'm thinking about doing this. I think that's
because that
totally
puts
fair
all
on your
of
part.
Us on the spot.
But to have us be flat-footed and go, wait,
right.
What now?
Oh, well, yeah.
So
you saw that I had a discussion with Lynn about it. I just haven't figured it out yet, but it seems like a high likelihood.
So then it brings us to how this council reacts to that motion, because we're on a big old crunch. If we don't start doing, today we really should have decided on what our questions are going to be for interviews.
Right.
I have shared some things. We need to set up what we're looking for in candidates, especially for planning and zoning. We need to get ourselves ready because if we don't start interviews like right after April 11th, we're in a pickle.
Right, the timing is terrible.
Which can force other hands
right.
to do other things. And I would like us to be ready. So my thought is that I realize this, that what Darcy is saying, what she is proposing, where she is coming from is that it's not so much the process or the practice that she's objecting to, but it's that any decisions that are policy decisions that are made within a committee need to come to the full committee before they're adopted. However, I am going to say that on a very practical sense, if this motion is made, then not only will the idea of policy be a question and a discussion, but I am expecting full well that our practice will also be up for discussion because what we're basically asking is for the full town council to weigh in.
Right. Yeah. No. That's what the effect of it would be. So, you know, some people may argue, yes, that principle is correct. In the future, we should do this, but let's do another one-off of the many one-offs that we've done because of the timing of this.
I just want to be ready because I know how long it took us to get to this point.
Right.
So I would like us to think about, and I know that Lynn originally, when she said, and I can't remember if she said this in a meeting or if she said it just to me, that she believed that it should come before the full council and that I should do a PowerPoint with her and Evan to present to town council. This was a while ago. I do not want to be caught in a situation where we are putting it out there, and it could be that I'm a worrier, and I over-worry, right? Except that I don't want to be caught not having something.
Has the town council, the rest of the council seen in the packet at any time this process?
I mean, it's public. I mean, I don't know whether they've cared.
It's just never been in the packet.
Well, just like I wouldn't, I mean, I wouldn't hand them our individual, like, here's this tree, here's that tree, here's this random tree. Well, I'm looking at the, we can't even remember what our things are.
They haven't seen the one that we voted on.
No, we voted not to give them that because we wanted to just get on with.
And we wanted to present the process in the context of their recommended appointees.
But we may not be in a position to do that. We may be in the position that we have to put forward to the entire council, not only the policy of whether or not the full town council has to vote to adopt a policy before of a council before they use it, but also that we're not going to have to defend our practice and whether or not we can get on with it. So as a chair, I'm really feeling sensitive to the fact that we were charged with doing this important thing, these appointments. We have done our work. We are ready. I do not want to be put into a situation where we are then dragged way past the 11th, and it makes it almost impossible for us to then finish our charge in a timely manner. That's the only thing that I'm thinking, is that I want to be able to still be able to do our job in a timely manner. Remembering that Patriots Day comes up.
Do we not have a meeting that day?
We do not have a meeting on Patriots Day.
So, you know, there's that. There's going to be a week that neither town council nor we meet. Unless we decide to change it, or I ask Lynn respectfully to call a special meeting of the full town council just for this topic, so that we can get it over, done, and we move on before you're on.
I don't think that's a bad idea.
So I would say a couple things. First of all, all of this is unnecessary unless the council votes that we have to present the process and have them adopt it. Our discussions have centered around the fact that we are developing our charge says make recommendations to the town council. Those recommendations need to be approved. The process through which we make those recommendations, as far as I'm concerned, do not need to be approved by the council. And it doesn't make sense for us to present a abstract process to the council absent those recommendations, and especially given the fact that the council has not sit in on what I imagine has been 20 hours of debate in this room and the glass room about this. My hope is that this committee, should that come forward, will make that clear to the council. As far as calling a special meeting, that's your decision as chair, and I understand your reason for doing that.
Wouldn't be necessary if we
I don't think it's necessary, and honestly, just personally, I am swamped right now in everything and don't know how I could fit a fourth April council meeting. That would be four April council meetings.
So
right? Because we voted to have an April 29th meeting as well. So I think that I understand you're trying to check all of our boxes and do all of our just in cases, but my preference would be not to have, or let me say this, the absolute last resort would be a special meeting.
Right, well I feel exactly the same way you do. I would hope the process would go the way we talked about and that we don't have to do it. I guess the only thing that I was thinking was all of us to just put it in our minds if it goes the way that I hope it doesn't go, and then we're put in that position. So I guess that's the only thing. I guess think about how we'll be able to recover or present or do that.
I think we just have to make the case to the council that given the reasons that both of you have presented, that it would not be advisable to subject this to a full council review, let us go through the process and see how it goes, But if the council decides otherwise, then we're back to where we're back to your problem. But it's going to be a decision by the council at that point, if that's what happens.
What I would probably prefer, if we have to do it, is to use one of our meetings, our OCA meetings, and say, if any councilors are interested in our process, we will be discussing it at the OCA meeting, and you can sit in on that or something like that, as opposed to calling a full special meeting of the town council. I would be more willing to start one of our OCA meetings at like 8:30 instead of 9:30 and use that first hour to brief anyone who is interested on the process. But having a special meeting to me is like, I'm already so tired just thinking about it.
So what I'm hearing is that the majority view is that we should just give the process a chance, and if there are problems with it, then we'll have to revisit it. Is that what I'm hearing? And that if that we have to make that argument tonight to persuade them not to force us to a decision, just let the process go through and see how it goes, and you can always revisit it. And that may not be an issue tonight, but if it is, that would be the argument that I think some of us would make, and then it's the council's decision.
And I would encourage all of you to everybody to say how you are feeling. It's important
right.
to all of us as a team, Darcy included, obviously.
Right.
I think that we need to just communicate how we feel, and then
okay.
we'll go from there.
Okay.
I'm actually incorporating some changes into the report, but the only thing I'm actually doing is changing something that didn't get changed yet, that what it's been established versus the town
yeah,
manager
I
told
thought
us
I had,
something.
Yeah, okay.
But you don't have to agree with all these changes,
yeah,
but now it's in track changes. And I changed it to 2019, because even though it feels like an April Fool's joke, it's not actually. It just feels like one.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're able to move on now?
Yeah,
or not?
We're
yeah.
able to.
Okay. To what would be the next
So now
item?
We understand how the process will work.
So yeah.
In real time, kind of just unfolding.
Yeah.
So moving right along. So the interview process, I could not find the questions that George originally had
right.
sent
to me.
That.
Yes, we did.
We had it's in our packet, and we even edited it one of the weeks. We did.
We did,
okay,
but then
so
we couldn't find it.
But then we couldn't find it.
Okay.
What a shocker.
I know.
Yeah. This whole thing is not. It
Sorry,
is just not freaking
really
easy. It is so not easy. It is freaking me
well,
out
I think
how
if we found
uneasy
it.
This all is. Okay.
Have you ever thought of having paper copies?
Yeah, but they.
You know, and just look at it and there it is.
Yeah, who would make them for us?
Oh, you don't have a printer or something?
No.
Oh.
No, we're just left to our own devices.
Right, so
yes.
I'm not seeing
we don't. Town council does not get paper packets like the select board used to.
Oh God.
No, trust
That's
me.
Tough.
I wish we had paper packets.
Yeah. We're not.
So Evan, at the moment, we're struggling to simply find the
yeah,
document
find
that presents the questions
Is
and
just
what we.
There,
what are you looking for? The interview questions?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're in one of our meeting packets, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I couldn't find them.
So it's probably an
annoying
repeating what everyone said.
Yes,
I wasn't at the 18th, so let's look at the 4th. Nope.
No, it was really, no, it was probably the 25th.
Gonna be there.
Yeah.
Interview protocol draft is 2/25/19.
Thank you. Can we move that to?
Yeah. Well, let's double check here what's going on. Why
remember.
Is one called one and one called? They're
I
not both dated. Let
so
me double check. It looks like I may have edited one, but not dated it. God, why would I do that? Who does this?
Yeah, there it is.
1 point.
Who does this?
Yeah. It doesn't have a title either for
Well.
So I think the one that was last edited by Darcy.
Might be more.
Is the one that's most up to date. That's the one that has danger, danger in it, which I think is the one that you actually were taking notes in.
Oh, I have the 225 one has danger.
Yep, yeah, I think that's the most up to date one.
The one that says Alyssa on it?
The one that was modified by Darcy.
I wonder if they're just duplicates.
I don't think they are.
The one that the other one does not have edits.
Okay,
it doesn't
so,
have danger,
yeah.
Danger.
This is the Darcy one that has interview protocol draft 2.
I have
yes.
2 with danger. I'm like
how do you
ready
have 2?
To walk.
The first
I am
says,
so done with this.
The first says preliminary steps. Jen Weston can help with setting up interviews. Let them know who will be part of the process. Do we want to arrange these ourselves? How to coordinate some questions ahead of time?
I have 2 separate documents that look exactly the same. In
how?
I don't. I'm feeling very fortunate that I actually found one that says the same thing that yours does. So,
Interview Protocol Draft 225-19.
Is what the name of the document is.
Last modified by Darcy.
I've got 1,000 different folders.
Hi, Darcy.
I don't even know.
You're
honestly.
Sure.
There's not enough coffee in the world.
No, there is not.
All right, so we actually need to change this because, in our process, we're not reviewing the CAFs until we decide what, after we talk to the chair of a committee and ask them if there are any special skills, qualifications that they're looking for in new members that would help round out their committee.
Yes.
I'm wondering if we want to kind of put this in as like an official procedure so that the next OCA, when we're all gone away, would know that that's something that we do.
That seems like a good idea. What are we doing today? Are we just voting on this?
Well,
or did we already do that?
No.
No, we have not voted on this, and it's not really ready, I think.
We need to have the interview questions ready. And vote on those. And I would like to just, if we're going to do a protocol, I'm just thinking if we could just stick in something that we're doing, it makes more sense than having to do it later.
Mm-hmm.
So when you go through, there is a vacancy. Vacancy has been posted for the chair for 14 days. So step 3 would be chair of OCA, requests, inquires to the chair.
Just contacts the chair and what asks.
I just put special skills, I think, and qualifications that they're looking for in a nominee that would help. I'm going to say round out. I hope somebody has a better word. Make stronger.
We've written this like 40 different times because we wrote it once to Greg, we wrote it once to Mark, we wrote it like it doesn't need to be like totally precise. But yeah, it's the whole knowledge, skills, abilities. But I mean, look at one of the, you added the one, the exchange you had with Greg, I think is in our packet.
Yeah.
They both are.
Yeah.
Mark Parents should be too.
Yeah.
And
it
includes the question you asked him,
it
right?
Does
not
it.
Just the answer. So just copy the text from
right.
the question
right.
into this thing. We don't need to keep refining it every freaking time we ask it.
All right, so boom, shakalaka. At some point, I will put that in, unless somebody else wants to do it right now. I'll put that in there here. And then review CAFs and see who's interested. Contact those interested to set up interview. Everybody should be interviewed, yes. Limit interviews 20 minutes, schedule 3 per hour. Is there any discussion on any of those things?
I'm sorry, say it again.
She's just going through the process and trying to get a sense of whether we're okay with it. So she's gone through 1 through 6, which is now 1 through 7.
Now we'll be 1 through 7.
And the document I am now working from is called Interview Protocol Draft 225-19 and 4-1-19, and it's in today's packet.
You've moved to today's packet?
Yes.
Thank you.
So let's take a pause and shift to that.
Okay.
It is literally that same document saved as this. And so now we don't go back anymore to February 25th. And now we're here. Now we're in real time. Over here. In today's packet.
Today's packet.
All right, so then.
So now we no longer have to go back to February 25th decision.
So on the 311 decision tree, I guess I'm down below. Council president isn't on it anymore, right?
We did remove that, yeah.
Yes. Yes, so we should remove that from here too, right? What happens if I open this in Word and make changes to it and you don't open it in Word, you just edit it online?
I've wondered about that too.
How does all that work magically?
There should be some way to save things so that people can't just go in and edit.
But we actually want to be able to, but yet we don't want to overlay each other's.
We can all edit together, right?
So I think if we just have it all open this way, but if one of us actually fully opens it in Word, so you could actually see the bloody track changes, which would actually be useful, as much as I hate track changes, those we can't see in this version, but we can see our words show up. What did you just add, Darcy?
I just took out the council president of down below.
So 2-2, Roman numeral 2,
yeah.
Item 2.
Oh, so it didn't go off yours?
No, I don't have anything on mine either, so I don't know what you're doing.
Oh, whatever, refresh.
Are you an interview protocol draft with the 225 and the 4-1?
No.
I don't think she is, no.
That's why.
Okay.
So to go back to our today's packet.
Okay.
And open that document.
You could individually send me edits to my email before I send it up.
And again, you're asking, I just want to be clear on what you're going to be asking Paul.
So, this is what I have, is that could one of us go to their meetings? Now, I'm assuming that's only the resident advisory committee? Because we don't know if the CPOs have meetings.
I'm uncomfortable with that. I understand the town manager's concern. It's really, there's the separation here. So you may go ahead and do this if you wish, but I'm uncomfortable with asking him if one of us, whoever that may be, can be present at an RAC meeting. Though apparently it's a public meeting, right?
Yeah,
so that's a non-issue. We can be there if we want to be. And if people want to go, they can go. The CPOs they do meet apparently, but what, that's a meeting between them and Paul, I guess. It's a staff meeting, right? It's not a public meeting. So I think we should, I don't see any reason for us to be present at those meetings.
Would you like me just to request that? So they're going to,
we just like to know what they're doing.
So CPOs have to write regular reports.
Oh, okay.
Which will be sent to us.
All right. That may be sufficient.
We could just ask if there's some way that they could check in with us.
Well, maybe the reports will do. I mean, they have a lot on their plate, and they're taking this on in addition to their regular duties. So this is and they seem to be eager about it and so forth. So maybe reports will be sufficient for the time being. If we feel, I guess, over time that we're really not getting much and we're not getting the reports aren't very helpful, then I guess we could say, could you please come and see us? But maybe we should allow them some space. They seem to be doing good work. They seem to be excited about it. Maybe we just lay low for a bit and see what's going on. Not even ask them to say, well, we want you to come once a month. As long as if we're getting reports from them, let's let it go for a couple months and see how it goes. And then if we feel that we're not getting enough information and we feel like we're out of the loop and we don't know what's going on and we're in the dark, then I guess we could ask them to come and see us. But I don't know. What do you think?
I feel like they've already told us.
They've already told you, right. So why are we going back again?
I don't really want to push.
Yeah. And I don't see the reason to push at the moment.
So I guess the bigger question for me then is, what is OPA's role
in
outreach and communications?
Right.
At this point, the only thing I can think of is one, helping people plan for and to recruit people to come to residents to come to public hearings and forums. asked Paul about this, he said trying to get residents to come to these is not, should not be our job, but it should be the job of staff.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what I'm going to bring up to you about this, is that, so when you think about planning a forum, or you think about planning special meetings, like hearings, like Finance Committee is doing, right, and we have the, we have two, at least a minimum of two public forums that we have to hold for the budget and for something else that is now escaping me.
School committee?
I think it's the capital plan.
Yeah, it's the capital plan, yep. So, what I did was, I don't know if you guys have this, or I don't think I put it in.
Right, I have them.
As to how to plan for a district meeting or office hours, and as I go through this, I feel like this sort of covers, so one is call 413-259-3002 or email boystonj@amherstmass.gov, and then townmanager@amherstmass.gov to secure a meeting space. So that seems like a logical first, my case being that I think that this is not setting up a public hearing or advertising for a public hearing or a forum could be done in a similar way. I don't know that I would change, so this is what I'm proposing to you. So that you would follow the guidelines for a district meeting or office hours for a hearing or a forum. And the only things that I changed was,
so who you're suggesting that for?
So here's my question. So one of the things that people are saying could be our role is if somebody wants to have a forum or they want to have a hearing, right? So say Finance Committee or one of the two forums that Town Council itself has to hold, right? The president is in charge of that, of those.
Right.
Then they need to do all the same things we would need to do if we were doing a district meeting. You have to get a room.
And that isn't something that staff is already doing?
Well, that's what I'm saying, is that if you look at that list right there, what I'm posing to you is that the guidelines for that, except for a few things that I changed, could also be the guidelines for, I'm going to come down.
For us, for setting up a hearing.
Yeah, it doesn't need to be us. What I think is that this could be, as Paul said, this could be his staff, which also means community participation officers, would be doing this, because it seems like it makes more sense to me, because except for on there, I believe I added, when you're trying to reserve a room, you could ask for, if you need microphones, and the right, is it set up in a room, you would ask for microphones, you could ask for PowerPoint, right?
So isn't something that they would just normally do anyway?
Right.
It hasn't been publicly stated that they do this. There is
that the CPOs
form.
Do it?
Right. Right. I wanted to send an email with just a few changes to say to CPOs and town manager, it seems to me, and with talking with Paul, who said that he felt that this was should be also under the purview of the CPOs, not making sense.
Well, it's not clear what this is now.
Okay, so
you're talking about
setting up. So there's two things. One is setting up and organizing a public hearing.
Or
a forum.
Well, never had a public hearing yet, correct? We've never had a public hearing, and those are set by the council, right? The
mm-hmm.
council is
yes.
the council and the president, I
yes.
assume,
yes,
does
do.
This.
Yes, that's what's in the charter.
Right.
It's
so,
been suggested to me by Finance Committee and also by Lynn.
Yeah.
That they believe that it is OCA's responsibility to advertise for these special type meetings, and it's up to us to get residents to come in.
Okay.
What Paul said is he does not feel that that's up to us, that actually all of the things that the community participation officers do to advertise for and bring people in for things like district meetings should be sufficient and the same.
Right. I don't
which
see
is
that.
Posting it on the website,
right?
All of those things, whether posting the meeting, posting it on
right.
the website.
Right.
You could post it on individual counselors' pages. some of the suggestions were that we could ask for an outside bulletin board on which we would post posters, or that we could have each counselor would find people in their district, or we would, to find people to put up posters in different districts. I don't necessarily know that I see myself running around.
No, I think this is getting down to the level of staff and sort of, you know, I thought our job was really oversight, just trying to make sure that first of all, nobody knows who's had a district meeting yet or not, I mean, as a group. So it'd be nice if the council actually knew.
We do have a council calendar now.
Right, so I guess you go to council calendar and you can look at it. But it might be useful to just have a report at some point or some kind of at every council meeting, said here's what's been happening on the outreach front. You know, there's been these district meetings and da-da-da-da-da. But maybe you're thinking, oh, as long as it's available on the calendar, people can go and find out what's going on. So we don't need to do sort of oversight in that sense. That's taken care of by the calendar. Do we need to coordinate? Do we need to make sure that these meetings are not all happening on the same weekend or the same month or whatever? Do we need to worry about that? Who oversees the sort of overall coordination of district meetings? So, and they're sensitive to, would they raise a flag if they felt like, you know, A, somebody's not having them, or B, they're all turning out to be on the same month or all on the same weekend?
Is
that something we should even worry about?
Well, so here's the thing. So if you want to post an event, right, that you're doing,
damn.
I believe right now it goes through, you have to submit an agenda and you have to submit, let's see if I can find it.
Right.
Goes through Jennifer.
Right, goes through Jennifer.
So all those things go through her, and
right.
Then there is a council calendar with which we can communicate with each other, right? So if George, you're saying, I'm going to have one this Sunday. I'm going to have a district meeting this Sunday. When I go, because I also thought this would be a great weekend for me to have one, I will see that you are also holding
right.
one.
The calendar might prevent that.
And I believe
that, right.
that what is expected is that counselors have enough common sense to not, you know, put all of our meetings on the same day.
Well, I just think counselors have so much they're doing that, yeah, but you're right. I mean, just pay attention.
Well, we
didn't
bring that up. I mean, that is one of the things is that, you know, how to help counselors communicate with each other better. If there's something that you feel like counselors should be doing in addition to posting things on the calendar, then we could bring up the fact that we think that counselors would report together from certain districts, what they did either for office hours or for district meetings, and you could even say they should report out on what they're planning on doing in the next 3 months, 2 months, if applicable. Do you think that that's an extra
step?
Yeah,
no, I think that's a good idea. Actually, it probably would be good also to have like an agenda item at one meeting where we just have, you know, a half an hour or two for each counselor to say, this is how my district meetings have been going, and these are the things that have worked, these are the things that haven't worked.
Because
I don't know how else we can have that discussion, because we can't just
Well, we have
a
place for counselor comments at the end of the meeting, so in theory, one could always use that as a way of doing that. But you're thinking making it a permanent or sort of a way. Our meetings are long enough.
I know, nobody wants to hear it when we get to that.
No, by that point, nobody wants to hear it.
All 13 of us should have a half an hour?
No, no, no.
I think that, you know, maybe 10 minutes for each.
Even 10 minutes. Even 10 minutes is 130 minutes.
Counselor, you can switch off, however, one counselor from the district.
Right. You don't want to hear about the district meetings, George?
Well, I'm just saying, George
yeah.
was wondering about, and this is something that's come up, like
our meetings are
5.5 hours.
Helping
us to communicate with each other. So
yeah.
if you think that would be something that would be helpful, that is something that we could ask about.
Yeah.
If you think that the calendar probably isn't enough, but we need to sort of be...
I'm just trying to get a sense, as you are, and I think all of us are, trying, what is our job? And I don't want us to be involved in, you know, putting up posters and,
yeah.
and you know,
You
that kind of stuff.
You don't want to scout your district for
well,
trash?
Well, that's what I do in my district, but it's not the job of this committee to do the job
right.
for the council. I mean, people, I don't have office hours, for instance, and I'm not going to have office hours. I don't think that we're going to insist that everybody have office hours. I do other things. So, I guess the question is, do we want to try at least have a sense of, as a this subcommittee or this larger committee,
mm-hmm.
do we want to have a feel for what's working what isn't, what's being done, what isn't, or we just kind of, maybe right now, we just let 1,000 flowers bloom and we'll see what happens. That's fine. But it sounds from the charge we were given, outreach communications in particular, that we sort of are supposed to be kind of paying attention in a broad way to what's happening. Mm-hmm. And there are, you know, you go to the calendar, you can, by word of mouth, people learn, oh, Ryan's got a newsletter, somebody else does office hours, somebody else does this, somebody else does that. But there's no, you know, do we need to, as a, this group, do we need to sort of just put that all in one place for ourselves to get a sense of how things are going?
So,
yeah, just so we have a feel for how things are going. Or do we need to say, as long as things are happening, fine, you know. Because
we want to ask people to report to this committee.
Well,
nobody's going to be
able
to come to this time.
No.
Or we could just have them report by email.
Right.
We could have a little survey for them to fill out. Okay, so what are your upcoming dates? What are your past dates? What, you know, what are the elements? Could you give us a sample agenda for your meeting so that we can all take a look at it? And, you know, who have you had as your guests? What's worked and what hasn't, and I think people would be glad to fill something like that out.
I think it would help all
a survey.
No.
It would probably help us, like maybe at the end of this year or next year or 3 years, to be able to leave some concrete guidelines and procedures and help for other counselors. I mean, I think that everything we do is establishing a process.
So that would. Would that be deliberation, or would that just be procedural, you know, like just, it seems to me like it's not deliberation on any particular issue before the council or anything, right?
I don't think so. I mean, I think that if this subcommittee wanted to come up with the, you know, finalize that idea and then come up with, say, a questionnaire, say that, I don't know, it could even just be sent simply to the chair of the committee, and then the chair would report out.
Well, here we're thinking of counselors, I think. We're thinking of the 13 counselors and what they are doing in terms of outreach and communications.
Right.
Literally what they are doing,
right.
And secondly, if they want, what success or what advice or what, you know, what's worked and what hasn't.
Yeah,
is that something
like
we want to do as a
Survey Monkey or
a
Google
right.
form or something
right.
like that? People could fill out a Google survey.
And how important is it for the council to have sort of like a broad picture of what at the moment, at some given time, say in 2 months or whatever, this is what is happening on the outreach and communications front, in terms of this is how many district meetings have been held, this is how many office hours are being held, this is how many. You know, newsletters, whatever. I mean, just a general statement of where we stand. And that would be something I would think we could provide as a service to the council if we want to take it on.
I think the Hampshire Gazette would be interested in that story. You know, like
maybe.
How is the new council functioning as far as, you know,
outreach and communication?
Yeah.
And
like, was it fulfilling its promise
so
of public participation?
Right.
As we brought up before, just something to think about. If we are seeing our role as sort of gathering information,
right.
being a committee that sort of keeps an eye on, you know, a timeline, you know, there's so many forums have to be, you know, by the town council have to be held in a certain, within a year's time. Like those kinds of things, should we have a timeline for some of those things? Do we want to establish that? And then do we want to just maybe check in, ask the RAC and community participation officers if they could report out either to, I mean, I'm going to guess to us, or
well, you told us this, but
do we want to have a sense of what, like, broad outreach is? Or do we want to just concern ourselves with town council's outreach?
Looking at our charge, but
it
is focused on town council, which seems appropriate. And I think at some level we should be providing some sort of overview or picture occasionally, a snapshot of what is happening and what people think is working and what isn't. And as you said, to how successful have we been in this first 6 months or whatever at actually getting people engaged, involved, in terms of, we as a council, how well are we communicating? We as a council, how well are we doing outreach? However we define outreach. Certainly that would include district meetings, public forums, office hours. I think it also includes, but this is a whole other area, of what we do individually in terms of reaching to, I mean, I go to a lot of groups and talk to people about what we're doing. I consider that an important task, a job that I'm supposed to do, I'm particularly working with students, but I'll talk to anybody, and I'm sure others are doing the same thing. But there's no list or record of that. I mean, I keep a record of what I do, but, you know, it, would it be worthwhile or valuable for people to know, you know, where counselors have been going and who they've been talking to as a sort of outreach function? Or is that, you know...
I think it would be.
And so counselors would report. I mean, I would report. I would write down on a piece of paper or on a form or whatever. I'd say, okay, in the past month or two, these are, you know, I've talked to Interfraternity Council. I talked to Panhellenic Council. I talked to MassBurg. I talked to the UMass Democrats. I talked to this neighborhood association. I talked to that neighborhood association. You know, so you list it. In part, simply to, if someone says, you know, you guys really don't, you know, reach out, you don't talk to anybody. Well, look, here's a list of, you know, 30 outreaches that happened by various counselors. What we would be the sort of repository or sort of the clearinghouse for this, so that we could at some point in 5 months, 6 months, whatever, be able to give data, be able to give actual factual data. This is how many public, you know, this is how many were held, this is how many newsletters there are, this is how many, you know, district meetings have been, this is how many office hours have been held, and, you know, just, that seems important.
I agree, and just
and
so
that would be our job.
So our charge is, one, communications and outreach, A, advise the town council on matters related to district meetings, section 2.7, public forums, section 2.13 and 5.3, and other strategies to broaden participation, ensure regular and transparent communication, and outreach to residents of Amherst. So I think being a repository of, especially this first year, what people, counselors are doing, and what sort of their sense of what is working and what isn't working, I think would be great. And I also think that it might be within our charge to then, maybe we could, or it would be for us to maybe make a small packet for counselors going forward that gives them some, you know, some of the guidelines that we were given by the community participation officers, and then some, maybe some guidelines that maybe we, or tips that we have, you know, seen work in the past, you know, coming year or 2 years. I'm just thinking that given having a structure is definitely helpful. I mean, we none of us had a structure to begin with. We're all finding our way. I just think that as we're finding structure, we might want to pass things on to next counselors just so that they can be somewhat up and running or have an idea instead of starting from scratch.
So there's best practices, which we could work on. And then there's just data.
There's
two different things. Here's what's been happening. And here are some best practices for going forward.
Which we may not know until the end of our third year.
Right, and maybe, but
you know,
whatever.
Quite
right.
Honestly, right. You know, there's right. We're all finding things out by trial and error. We haven't been through a full budget process. We haven't been through, you know.
So maybe one step would be, concretely, would be for this subcommittee to consider reaching out to all the counselors by email and saying, you know, one of the things we think we should be doing is just keeping some kind of account of outreach that's been going on the council since we've been created in December. So it's asking them to do something, which I know myself, it's like, oh. But could you begin to assemble a list of some of the, you know, things, tell us your office hours, if you had district meetings, when and where. At this point, we're just collecting data. We're not interested in the agendas. We're not interested in that. We just want to know what are things you've been doing in terms of outreach. Is that something that we should add to the list to-do list for our other counselors? Would that be useful? With the thought that eventually we would tabulate this and present it to them and say, here's a record of what you've been doing over the last, you know, 6 months. And also a record we could then share with the public and say, you know, if you have a question, here's what we've been doing.
And so what Darcy suggested, and I don't know what you think about it, is doing it maybe in poll form, which some might be somewhat easier checking out boxes.
I think this is going to be, unfortunately, people really have to sit down and list. You know, I've talked to this.
Well, you can do that in a poll form. Well, okay. The advantage to doing it with a, you know, SurveyMonkey or mm-hmm. Google survey mm-hmm. is that the result comes out on a spreadsheet
mm-hmm.
that people can look at.
Right.
It's easier to, you know,
yeah.
to the result is easier to manage
right.
than if
so
you just
how we shape
if you just got, you know, like right. 13 emails.
Lists of, right, yeah.
Emails,
you'd have to
you'd
go
have
through
to,
and organize that. I understand. Right.
Who would there be places that, because I don't know what I've done.
Well, a task for the subcommittee then, painfully, would be, because who needs another task, but would be to construct something like this.
yeah.
To construct a document that you feel
yeah.
would be, provide sufficient data, useful data, and that would take a little bit of time for some of us to figure out,
right.
I guess.
I could do that. It's not that hard.
Okay. And you could give us something like that to look at, and that would be great. And then we can refine it, and if we're satisfied with it, then we have something we can actually send out when we're ready.
Yeah, we can add, I mean, we can just look at a draft and figure out
exactly.
what we want to add.
Exactly.
Okay. But how about, like, in 2 weeks or something
like that.
Oh, that'd
be fantastic.
Yeah.
We didn't bring up at the previous meeting that we wanted. I want to meet next week.
Oh.
I'm sorry, what do you mean next week? Yeah.
Darcy wanted to make sure. Oh, no, next week we have it. It's the week after. It's Patriots Day.
Oh, we are meeting next week then.
Yeah, and then we can talk
good.
About it if people have time. To
okay.
That.
You have something next week is... Okay.
No, I just feel like we gotta meet every week.
I have just the opposite feeling. But that's all right. I think your feeling is the right feeling. Mine is the wrong feeling.
Yeah.
But
so,
last week when we didn't meet,
Merry
so
Christmas.
Good.
That's why I said Merry Christmas.
It's like snow day.
Yeah.
It's a snow day. I love it.
It's
terrible.
But
it's
wonderful.
Right.
All at the same time.
Okay. So Darcy is willing to sort of. Well, he's not sort of kind of willing to
yeah.
sort of construct this
yeah.
SurveyMonkey thing, and we'll look at it next time, and that could be useful for us in going forward. Anything else?
Do you
that,
want
yeah?
me? So we were kind of talking about the other thing that I think is hanging in the air and has not been resolved is how to set up the forums, and I was going to call it here. I don't know. So whatever we're calling special meetings that are being called by finance committee.
And you feel that this is something that we should be worried about rather than send it over to Paul, you were.
No, I don't.
Okay.
But I think there's a question out there that's been posed by the council president and also by the finance committee.
We've taken care of them already today.
Is that, you know, is this in our purview, both setting them up and the bigger part is bringing residents in? I do not think, and I've talked to Paul, Paul does not think that is our job. So what I would like to do is I put a couple changes on that. That just all it does is just add, like, you could ask for a projector, you could ask for microphones, you could ask.
I think
for
we
PowerPoint.
Can just tell them that we're not doing it.
Unless somebody can convince us that somehow it really is our task.
So what I would ask then is I would probably send something to both. I would CC them, and I would ask Paul, and I would ask. I guess I would ask. We don't feel like this is in our purview. Could you set up a how to plan for forums and hearings or whatever? I will figure out the right wording on that. Can you do a how to and send it to all of us? And we'd like to make it very plain so the question is officially answered by Paul and the CPOs, but mostly by Paul, that this is not advertising and bringing people, residents in. Special meetings is not the extra added responsibility of FOCA.
And they can just, you know, give suggestions to all the counselors about what they could put on social media or whatever.
See you.
Thank you, Phyllis.
Thank you, Phyllis.
I would like, before we end, I would like it if our committee could communicate with Paul about the whole neighborhood cleanup issue, because that email that we got from Paul directly asking us to scout our neighborhoods for trash really threw me, you know? I felt like maybe this is a really good idea, but I felt it felt odd to me for us to be getting that directly from the town manager rather than from either Lynn or from, I actually think it should have come from OPA.
So here's the thing, is it coming back to who works for who? Who hasn't, so what has been established that I feel, and that we just, we want to maybe have this as is established in writing, just so that it's there and it's not opaque, it's very clear that what I believe is being said, and we need to have this in policy or written down, is that the events outreach of the community participation officers. What I believe is being said is that community participation officers work for the town manager, and that all of their outreach, including things like this trash pickup day, is theirs. And theirs for recruiting new people for town manager appointments. They do not have anything to, they help individual counselors, the CPO helps individual counselors, and they help to bring in people for Paul's appointments, and they're helping to establish a broader community. I think what we've been told is that that's their bubble and it's not our bubble. I think that we really need that clarified. We need to really know like what that distinction is. So if we decided to do an event, do we do an event ourselves, OCA, for town council things, and then do we let them know? I mean, to me, that's the thing that's more confusing.
Well, I just feel like we're all reaching out to members of the community. And if the town manager wants us to participate in the district cleanup, I guess that's fine, but it seems it needs to be a more holistic process.
I agree.
He did come to our last meeting and bring it up, but there was no like agreement that we would then, convey to the rest of the council what we're doing because we're the outreach people for the council. It just feels like we were left out of that loop, and it didn't feel good when I got that, and it was like, oh, wait a minute.
So we need to really clarify what's being said and where certain purviews start and end, because my feeling from what was said was that, and this is the whole question that I have in general, is it OCA's job to plan events and to do certain procedures as town council's outreach to the community, are we completely separate, right? So that, you know, they're doing their town manager thing and then they can invite us. Is it being made clear, we need to make it clear, are we tagging along on things that they do? Or are people seeing that it is OCA's responsibility to hold these kind of events and to come up with our own outreach strategies that are completely separate from them? That's what I need to clarify. Because for me, it seems like what's being said is we're completely separate. And I feel that I need the clarification of are we completely separate or not? And then we could talk about how we want to go with that. But that's a big question. I agree.
So you're sort of saying, that we need to be working together it needs to be made clear if we're just like working parallel,
yes,
or whether
yes
we
yes
are helping each other
yes
do our
yes
different tasks.
Yes.
And it seems very clear to me that we should be doing both, you know, we should be working together and collaborating. So I think that we could express that to the town manager.
I think that's what he was looking for with this event, but it came obviously quickly, and it came, you know, I think someone came up with a good idea, or an idea, that Paul's had experience with, and I think one of the CPOs had experience with. And they thought, this is a great idea, this is a way to get people involved. And then they said, let's get the town councilors involved. So it that's how it happened. And I think, you know, that's a good thing. But there's still this confusion that we're going to have to resolve. But at this event, I think, was not designed to sort of him telling us what to do. It's, here's this idea, this is something we're going to do, we think it's a great idea for the community. Can you help us by doing X, Y, and Z? And in my case, I'm not sure I'll get around to going through my neighborhood and making a list of trash. But maybe I will. But I've already started looking. I'm sort of making notes in my head. So, but I didn't see it as an order or some kind of usurping of power. I just thought, they got this great idea, they're going to run with it, you know, and this is a way we could help. So I will try to help if I can, and I'll try to show up on the day, because I think it's a great thing. But going forward, and maybe it'll become an annual thing. But I'm not so much worried about it. I don't think it was an attempt to sort of tell us what to do. It's just, you know, cooperate with us, collaborate with us if you can. And if you can't, you can't.
We should have been looked in, though.
So maybe this is the process question.
Yeah, it's all new.
This is the process question that we're all learning and that we need to lay down. And that's why I want to get clarification of how we're going to do
what
that.
What the spheres
future,
are, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So that it doesn't seem weird or.
Okay.
All right. Let's get
adjourned. I think, yes, we have one action item.
My survey?
If you would, and it's, that'd be great. If you can do that, it'd be great. And then we'll look at it, we'll talk about it. And that's in 2 weeks, not next week. So that's actually 3 weeks then, because I think in the second week is Patriots Day, right? So next week we meet, but the following week is Patriots Day, so it looks like it's 3 weeks.
Unless we decide to meet that week.
Not a Patriots Day, for God's sake!
Not a Patriots Day, we have to move
at
the meeting.
Okay. Well, that's possible. It could happen. It could happen.
Just think all the training we can offer to people on SharePoint.
Right.
We
can make a living.
Right. Step one, delete it. Use Google Docs.
Okay. So now interview.
Now you're in there, kiddo. I can see your little flag. Uh-oh. Danger. Danger.
Danger. So now delete that line.
Did it show up?
Yes, it did.
Now there are only four items there.
And
two members of OCA.
Should be one.
Right. OCA designee.
OCA designee.
OCA designee. Is that what you called it in the vote? Yes.
That's right.
Oh, OCA, I thought we said chair.
No,
it could be. We could change it. It can be anyone.
We
but
voted
one.
To designate the chair.
Chair, but it could, we could.
What?
Right. OCA designee.
You're explaining. It's the OCA designee, which in this case, so the process is OCA designee, and you recently voted that OCA designee was the chair.
Sure.
Whereas in future,
they
that
could
OCA
say.
Designee
could
might
be
somebody
right.
else.
Right.
George.
And so we voted that the chair should just be for this process?
For the time being.
For the time being, but we could in theory change that.
Anytime we want.
If our chair comes back and says, I don't want to do this.
So I'm going to say this.
I had to have, because you're going to be busy.
Yeah, no.
You got the numbers from Paul about how many people have applied?
Yeah.
It's a lot.
Yeah.
Could have been more.
And
it's more than I expected.
When did we find out this number?
I asked Paul personally.
Jesus, what is this thing called process around here?
But he had said he had already told Sarah.
So let me just make something, I need to reel this back in. So
yeah.
I'm not saying, believe it or not, I'm not saying I'm right. I'm saying we need to make thoughtful decisions when we say things like this. So, in the past, it has always been true that we never told anyone how many people applied for a particular thing.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as we say that, you're now going to have the newspaper calling up Paul and saying, how many people applied for finance committee? And then he'll tell the newspaper, but he won't have told the entire town council. This is not a good position to be in. I just reminded him a couple of meetings ago that, because Margaret didn't know that because nobody bothered to tell her, that we don't release the number of people who've applied for committees until we figure out the as yet undetermined demographic method of reporting,
uh-huh.
where the town manager says, these are the three names I'm giving you, there were 25 names altogether, and X amount of them identified this particular way. If we start doing this way, then it's gonna be a free-for-all. So we need to think about if we're going to continue that, because it's not new, it would be a continuation of a new thing. But if we're just gonna say, oh, who cares, tell the newspaper every time they call how many people applied, that feels really uneasy to me, because that telling the newspaper is not telling the council. And I think if anything, the council should know more than the newspaper knows.
So the council should know before the newspaper knows.
Right, and the way the council would find out is by getting the demographic report from either this body, because we're putting forward names for planning board, and we're saying there were X number of applicants, here are the names we're recommending, and here's how people identified in that pool, but without all their names. That's when they get that information, is when we're making the recommendation, not now.
I don't think the desire for the number was motivated by any, it's just, we just were curious.
I asked them specifically because I was like, we need a timeline,
Just practice.
That gives you a
we
sense
have
of
cushion.
How many interviews
right.
you
right.
need.
We just have cushion if you come back and you say, the only people who have applied for ZBA are those currently on the ZBA.
Right. I'm asking personally, just don't report what the number is.
Okay.
So, because we're on camera, and don't report it to the rest of the town council either, because we're not ready for that yet. But that will be part of
right.
our report.
So we
to
can
the council.
Secretly pass a note around among us.
No, because then it would be a public document.
No.
Then,
yes.
then you've
no.
just now created a
but
public.
But you could ask me after this meeting, Crash.
But you shouldn't.
Right.
Because the only reason you're finding that out is to help us understand the interview process. Because
how
we
much
should
time
not
we need
be
for
in
interviews.
A position
right.
of knowing that yet as a group. Just as you apparently voted, right, when I wasn't here, that you didn't want to see the CAFs until after you firmed up
That's
the questions.
That's correct.
And
yes.
so, you know, we're trying to keep the wall there,
okay.
you know, and then take it down brick, I suppose, as we get further along in the process.
So, interview protocol.
So, OCA designee.
Who may at their discretion.
I made that
include,
change.
Right, town
yes.
manager, committee chair, staff liaison.
Process diagram.
Yes.
Adopted.
Okay. All right.
Am I just doing something like right here that nobody else can see either? I'm putting in number 3. Am I in the wrong?
You're probably in the wrong. If you have to be in today's agenda packet.
My tabs is interview protocol draft.
Sarah, you're not on this document.
I'm not?
No.
Okay. During posted meeting 02-2519 and 0419.
There's still a newer version.
In
the title,
today's meeting.
The
packet.
Title has to have.
It is in today's meeting.
We are having so much fun.
Oh, God, this is awful.
All right, well, I guess I'll find
no,
it.
No, you'll
after.
Find it, London. What?
We're worried about.
I'm walking down camera.
Multiple member body committee chair.
I don't
yes.
know how we can thank you for attempting to take minutes for such a meeting.
I can do
so.
I bet you do. I hope so.
These people, as I was telling Paul that I do this, people repeat themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So you only have to say it once.
Yep.
And that eliminates the whole thing.
That's true.
But what's this title? That's old. Okay. I don't know why that's there, actually. Any way to make it go away, I wonder. So what you should have.
So who wrote multiple member body committee chair?
You're in the wrong
room. Sorry?
Who wrote multiple member body committee chair? It's a purple flag.
It is Alyssa.
Alyssa. I just think committee chair is fine.
George.
All right, doesn't matter. Next.
How long do you want to argue?
Exactly. Not long. Trust me, not long.
Not just the head.
Yeah, was the length of the minutes I sent? Was that okay?
Yeah.
Cover everything?
Yeah. One thing I discovered in reading the lawyer's report on the open meeting law.
You're there.
I'm
sorry, go ahead.
No,
just,
she seemed to be saying we shouldn't be sending minutes around for people to review.
I thought that was garbage.
Well, that's
that doesn't
what she
really
said.
Make sense, but
that's
yes.
So,
because
don't
there's
worry.
There's a chance of an expression of opinion, except minutes aren't supposed to be expressions
right.
of opinion. They're supposed
that's
to be
poorly
just
written
a record of what was transpired.
I hear you.
All right, so you inserted multiple member body committee chair.
Yes, because it's
that's
like committee
mouthful.
Chair of what? I know, but
Okay.
And we can rephrase it. You can come up with a better phrase. What I'm trying to say is, no, but the committee, what committee chair?
Any
the OCA committee chair?
Whatever. Any free committee chair.
Town committees.
Relevant committee chair?
It is a town, right.
You'd say relevant committee chair, you know, appropriate. This is item two.
So under OCA, where it says, under who is present?
At your discretion, the designee may include town manager, if available, relevant committee chair, or just, I mean, I don't care.
Okay, if you like that better, I'm fine with that. I'll change it.
Yeah, relevant committee chair. Or just committee chair. I mean, you know, I mean, it's pretty obvious. It would be the committee that we're dealing with.
No, that's why I changed it, because it's not that obvious. You'd be surprised. Just like on charge documents, I don't like when they say later in the charge, committee, because I want to be able to copy and paste, and I want it to say finance committee, and I want it to say whatever committee.
Change that.
Exactly. I got something I wanted. It's so exciting.
All right, okay. Anything else?
So OCA designee who may at their discretion include relevant committee chair, if available, town manager, if available, staff liaison, if available.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, next. Roman three. All members of the interview team need to follow this protocol, not just OCA designee.
So that needs to change because.
There are all members.
Interview protocol for OCA designee.
Designee. That's right.
There's no one else.
That's right. So, any thought, hey, we got to get, number two needs to be edited.
Yeah.
The first one I think is okay. Does time commitment, homework required, when committee meets. So, maybe leave it at that. And drop everything after committee meets.
Okay. How do I want to phrase the fact that, okay, so most of these questions are, have you had any experience? They're mostly questions the OCA designee is going to ask.
Mm-hmm.
But the second one is to require that the committee chair or staff liaison do something. What if none of those people are there? How can we effectively describe, in less words than I would normally use, George, that says,
mm-hmm.
Why don't we just say, describe what committee does? Why don't we just do that? So why don't we just take all that out?
Say who.
Who's doing it? Describe what committee does, time commitment, homework required, when the committee meets, and major issues coming up without being leading, which we'll figure out a way to phrase. But that way, this is the OCA designee is doing this, or the OCA designee is turning to Nate Malloy,
right, exactly,
who happens to be sitting there.
Right,
or if Nate Malloy's not there, you know, then maybe the town manager
good.
Will
rather than assigning roles.
Or the OCA designee will have had to do a bunch more homework because they know that.
So
they're not going to
the
have any backup.
Somewhere it seems like
the charge will help. We should mention
the documents
charge.
That they should have there available.
That
the
is
charge.
A very good point.
The
that should be specifically.
Any other relevant committee documents?
Do we need to spell that out?
I think the charge, and like, I don't know, like, say if it was a housing committee and the housing production plan was hot off the press, I suppose you could end that. But I mean, these are only 20-minute interviews. They didn't have a lot of time.
Right.
So,
well, the charge, at the very least.
But
here we're trying to tell the designee how to
right.
do
so,
that. I mean, this is getting into the weeds,
the
isn't
charge.
It? Really? Okay.
To the applicant. This partly reflects back to the conversation that we had before about kind of quizzing them as to, like, do you have any idea what you're applying for? And have you ever been to any meetings, et cetera? So, provide the charge to the applicant. Describe what the committee does.
Didn't they get the charge earlier?
Yeah,
it seems a little late
like,
for them.
Like in 1-5?
Okay. All right. Contact those interested to set up interview.
And provide.
Provide a copy of the charge. And any other relevant documents.
Unless this is, again, going back to your little test of, like, do you actually know this committee that you apply for?
Yes. Right. But you could provide a copy of the charge and a link to the webpage, and they could be like, oh, good, I forgot to look at that. Or, yeah, and so we're
no,
helping them.
I think
them.
It's good.
We're helping them.
Fair enough. So put it up in front. Good.
Describe.
And remove two.
Based.
3-2.
Okay. Based on charge. We're going to change this again, but you're going gonna see where I'm going with it, so. And you're gonna fix it for me. So you're gonna wanna bring a copy of the charge with you anyway to the meeting. That's the other thing, is it's one thing to email it to the person, but you're not gonna be sitting there in your 20-minute interview trying to pull up the charge on your phone.
Right.
So you're gonna walk in, when you walk in, you're gonna have a copy of their CAF, and you're gonna have a copy of their charge, of the committee charge.
Okay.
CAF and charge on the table. Okay, so then we can just change it to describe what committee.
Describe what committee does, time commitment.
Go back to that, because I just said that there's already a CAF and charge on the table. This person's, is it clear that it's that person's CAF, not everybody's CAF?
Yes, it is, it is, okay, let's go, let's go.
I was gonna make sure that describing the, what the committee does, blah, 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 is actually done by the chair of the relevant.
The reason that I didn't write it there, I'm sorry, I was babbling about that earlier when we were trying to fix something, is that the reason we don't write that there is because if it turns out that they're not there.
Okay.
So they bail, or something happens.
They're not available, whatever.
And like, literally, it's, it could be just you.
Right, you have to, that's what you gotta do.
In which case, you'd be like, oh shit, I expected them to tell me this. So hopefully, they would give you enough notice that they could tell you what they would have said. Okay, so how do we, without, so how do we say the major, because people liked the idea of major issues coming up, but then didn't like the idea of making it so, say it was back in the day when One East Pleasant Street was coming up, right? We wanted to be like, do you have any idea that One East Pleasant Street is happening, but on the other hand, we don't want you to try and commit to what you think about One East Pleasant Street, because you're the committee has to decide that,
yes.
Not you.
Can I interrupt for a minute? I know this is, we need to finish this, but I know that we have other votes that we were gonna take today. We just wanna make sure that we have enough time.
Mm-hmm.
So,
What were the other votes?
So looking back at our agenda. At 11.
Pardon?
Are you having your other meeting at 11?
Yeah, I'm just thinking that we, I don't think we have much to discuss, but.
Yeah.
I almost feel like
I don't have to leave at 11, but I have a meeting with Kev at 11:45 that I'm running, so
latest
11:15.
So are the votes you're referring to, Darcy, the thing under consider change to our charge? Or were there other? Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
Good, that's four. I'm thinking,
so
please, there's enough.
Yeah,
okay.
I think the only two votes that I did is changing our charge to take out finance committee as something that we.
So these are proposals that were not necessarily, in fact, none of which were proposed by this committee. These are all proposed by the president who wrote the charge in the first place.
Right.
Okay.
But did I make that clear? I'm not sure if I made that clear.
Well, when you say we're taking votes, it's like, I mean, there's always the question of like, why do we want to do this? Because we're trying to be responsive to the president's concerns. Is that my understanding?
Yes.
As opposed to this was
so
any of our
I've never written a report before. So in the report that I wrote, I believe I just put the vote in because I thought that I was only supposed to do it and then put what prompted it. But if somebody would like to change that for me, like if you would like to put something else in, I'm open. I just have never done, this is my first baby.
I'm not complaining, Sarah. I'm just trying to understand.
No, but I mean, like, I don't know how to do it. So if there's something you're like, this is what is expected to be in a report, I would love to learn because I don't want to do it the wrong way.
We're making it up. We are literally making it up.
But so if there's
a
suggestion you want to make as to how the vote should be said, or the motion should be reflected, or it should be reflected differently in my report, then we can do that as well. I believe I did say that it was because we were asked by the president at our past meeting if we would do it.
I was just looking at two separate documents. I was looking at our agenda versus the report draft. And the report draft makes that clearer.
How do we want to go forward to accomplish whatever we have remaining before 11:15?
Okay, 11:15. So we have to 11:15. So we'll just try to do the best we can with it, I guess. I guess we're skipping over.
So we're going to put the interview protocol aside for now.
Yeah.
And we're going to come to what we should be looking at, Sarah, it sounds like from what you said, is we should be looking at the actual report, the draft report, more so than, and perhaps side by side with the agenda for today. That's closed.
I'm pretty sure that I put so, in the same way, but I have now not picked up.
Yeah, so we're just, that's, it's fine. We're trying to do things side by side and rearrange all this. Okay, so technical difficulties are a huge waste of time. Not our fault. So, Finance Committee.
Right.
Is this in today's posting?
I believe it is.
Yes, it is.
I'm not talking about the agenda, I'm talking about the posting.
Posting, yeah, I believe it is.
Taking resident appointments to Finance Committee out of our charge. Yes, thank you. So, I'm in this awkward position because I'm on rules. And so is Darcy. And this was referred to rules by the council, as you'll recall. And then the idea was that rules would get a crack at it first. And then I thought the idea was then OCA would get a crack at it. But so rules did talk about this. Then I got sick, various things happened. And no mention was made of it during the town council meeting that was like 10 days later after that meeting. So it was never discussed. However, it was reported by some rules members who are on the finance committee to the finance committee, and also by the president, who was there for the rules meeting and at the finance committee meeting, because she's part of the finance committee, what was discussed at rules. So the finance committee knows more about what happened than this body does. Yes, so that did not work out right. So that did not work out right. So, also, that written report has not yet been finished by me, which is supposed to be in tonight's packet for the entire town council, reporting out what we decided, which was, maybe Darcy could say it faster than I could.
We decided that the finance committee could do the finance committee would take from OCA the responsibility of interviewing candidates for the resident, non-voting residents of the finance committee, and of then choosing them, bringing them back to the finance committee to choose. In other words, they would set up a process. They said they would base it on our process, but that they would basically take that piece away from our responsibilities and do it themselves.
So I had heard that, and I actually spoke to that when Lynn asked me in our goals, meet the goals for the town council meeting, whether or not we addressed either of these things, and so it was brought up that that had been proposed. My feeling was only this, that it was in our charge, it was written in our charge, we had it in our charge. I realize that another committee can take this away from us because process that's been put forward. I simply wanted to say, oh, here's what's been proposed. I would just like us to weigh in on it, even though it may not matter. I just wanted to have us weigh in on how we felt about it. That may or may not be appropriate. Yes, Evan.
So, I have lots to say, but I'll try to keep it brief. So, first thing is, it's not in our charge. It doesn't specifically say residents to finance committee. So there's nothing to take. So I guess I'm a little curious because the wording of this is vote on taking resident appointments to finance committee out of our charge, but there's nothing take out of our charge.
Technically doesn't say.
It says make recommendations to the town council regarding all appointments by the town council. So we're not taking anything out. Are you saying we're voting to add to it that says except for.
Except that those were appointments of the president.
No, what I'm saying, we're not taking anything out of our charge. We're adding language to the charge that says except for. Correct?
Well,
is that what we're looking to do right now?
Well, wait. So if, I mean, Sarah wrote up just like a way to phrase the vote, not an opinion as to whether or not that should be the vote, right, in her report for tonight. So, for example, it says, uh, Communication Appointment Committee voted on 4-1 to or not to remove from its charge a recommendation regarding resident appointments to Finance Committee. You're
that's
right
not
that
in
it
our
doesn't
charge.
Say we could we should alter that
right.
phrasing in the report.
There's nothing
that
to take
references
out of the charge.
Town council appointments, which we currently believe the resident members to be
right.
town council appointments. And if they're town council appointments, then they belong to us. They are belong to us.
So we're not arguing to take anything out of our charge. We're actually arguing to add language to our charge to take something out of our
no. Well, no.
Right?
The only person who's arguing that is
no. That's with the
committee or
right. I mean, yeah. I'm talking specifically about this language here.
Yeah. So we're gonna fix that.
Right. Okay. Because you can't remove something that's not there.
Right.
That's my first thing.
To. Okay, so
we actually, if we do approve this, we're actually adding to the charge. We're not removing anything from the charge.
No, wait. Okay, the charge.
There's
right
nothing
now,
to remove from the charge.
Well, there is if we agree with rules.
What looking at this charge, what are we actually going to remove?
We make recommendations to town council regarding all appointments by the town council.
Right.
That's what we currently do. If we agree that finance committee should take that away from us, then we need to change our charge. If we don't agree, we don't need to change anything.
To what, though? Is what I'm saying. We're not removing any language
if
from
we,
the charge. We're
if
adding
we,
language.
If we agreed with them, we would change the charge and say, make recommendations to the town council regarding all appointments by the town council, except for
right. So I'm saying we're not removing anything, any language from the charge. We're adding language to the charge if we agree with them.
Well.
Okay. Yes, it's
that's
just a different way.
I'm sorry. I realize
yes.
we're on.
Yes.
We're saying the same
we're saying
thing,
the same
but we're on
thing,
different pages.
Ways. Yes, I get it. I get it now. Okay.
I'm talking about the physical language in our charge. Right. Right.
Right.
I'm saying if we approve this, we're editing the charge not to remove anything, but to add language that specifies.
Okay.
Okay. So that was sorry. That was more confusing than I needed to make it.
That's true. Recommendations to the town council regarding all. Instead of that, it should say regarding all appoint. I know I should be copy and pasting, but God knows I can't get
so,
all more documents.
So, what should the motion be then?
By the
town
council section 2.9. So, the question is whether or not recommendations to the towns to modify. Would be to modify if we were agreeing to do this, which no one is saying that we are at this point, is to modify. I'm working on Sarah's report right now. If you're trying to follow along,
right.
Modify its charge recommendation to the town council regarding all. The wording's bad, but it's currently says regarding all appointments to the town council. To clarify, I'm just making this up. To clarify that. Non-voting resident members, I pick up the language from the actual thing, are not recommended by the OCA. It's rough, but that's the general idea, is that it says the charge currently says all appointments by the town council. We're saying if we agree with what rules agreed to and what the finance committee seems to want, that we OCA would say, well, if we agree with you there, we would clarify that statement in
correct.
Our charge to say non-voting resident members of the finance committee are not recommended by the OCA, but by the finance committee.
Yeah.
Or we could just say it's just not ours,
right.
And then
okay.
wherever they go,
so how do we
that,
feel about this?
Problems.
How do we
so
feel
is there
about
discussion
this?
On
yeah.
that?
Okay. I have
is thoughts. There a motion for this?
The motion hasn't been made.
No
it's
that's
just been
right.
drafted so that we at
yeah.
least know what we're arguing
right.
about.
That's
what I
was so with respect to colleagues who are on the Rules Committee, this strikes me as really strange to make finance the only mm-hmm. committee in our entire town and council that decides its own members to appoint.
Mm-hmm.
I am also, and I don't know the details of this. This is the problem with everything, right? Is I wasn't there, so I don't know the discussion. So forgive me if I'm just saying things that you all already debated. But it seems to me very strange that finance committee would choose its own members, which is a luxury that we give. I would actually love to say, Mark Parent, you're in charge.
Yeah.
You choose your new ZBA members, and then
right.
you don't have to do any interviews, and you can take a nap, right?
Why don't we?
And so,
yeah.
to me, it's a really strange thing.
Yes.
I also think it's interesting. There's also a level of curiosity I have about the debate, given that two of the members of the Rules Committee are on finance.
Oh.
three? Is it
three?
Two.
Two are on finance.
But
plus
I have
the
feeling
president
Lynn was probably at the meeting.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
she was.
So, who also, so the president, this is a recommendation from the president who also serves on finance, and so that seems to me an interesting dynamic.
Dynamic. Let's go with that. Yes.
I'm not quite sure why this makes any sense
right.
at all,
right.
and why, if we are charged with appointments to the town council, that we would make a special carve out
mm-hmm.
for finance committee. It seems to make this committee,
yeah.
it gives this committee a strange status that we are giving to no other committee. So I personally would love a good rationale for why this committee should be treated with such luxury.
So I was told by our president and by members of the finance committee that finance is a very special committee that has to have very special qualifications, and that
unlike ZBA.
So just listen to me, because
I know I'm hearing you. I'm sorry, I don't want to talk over you.
That only people who have served on finance committee would be able to figure out who is qualified to be on finance committee. My argument was the same as yours, was that I believe the planning board and zoning board are very special committees
mm-hmm.
that have very special
mm-hmm.
qualifications. So what would then be the difference? And if you were going to change this charge, what makes me think you're not going to then come and say, or that we should, if you're looking at consistency, say, planning board, guess what? Your chair gets to, you guys get to pick because you have special qualifications. Zoning is definitely the same, I think the same way, very specific in its qualifications. So I can't answer that. I struggle with the exact same question. And I have posed that question, and what has come back to me is, this
okay.
seems to be the argument.
We need to make a motion because we have another vote.
Okay.
Three more, don't
we? Have language that they feel is
so it would be, I think, somebody help me out here, to modify its committee charge, to modify. It's modify the charge that currently specifies recommendations to the town, OCA makes recommendations to the town council regarding all appointments by the town council, charter section 2.9, to clarify that non-voting resident members of the finance committee are not recommended to the town council by
can
the
OCA.
No, it's like wicked awkward.
We can. We have to fix this, and then
yes.
we can always just email the language.
Yeah.
Okay.
Modify.
Yeah.
Competitive, and you need to.
But at the moment,
the
we're not
OCA
hearing the
committee charge that currently, because that's what we're trying to show, is that it's changed, that currently includes recommendations to the town council regarding all appointments by the town council charter, to clarify that non-voting resident members of the finance committee are not recommended to the town council by the OCA.
What if we simply don't act on this?
Then it gets taken away from
us. If we just,
we
why we worry about wording this, since nobody, I mean, just
I
if we decide
well,
not to act on it,
so,
we, nothing happens.
Right.
No, they're going to go ahead and do it.
Is this, can I ask you a question?
No, they can't. We have the charge. The charge says we have control.
Oh.
So if we don't.
Can I ask a question to rules people? Is this being brought forward separate from the rules package for town council to vote on? Or will this be brought forward as part of an overall rules package that we vote on?
So, the timing is such that this needs to be decided before the package gets brought forward. So just like we had a recommendation on form of address, and we had a recommendation on public comment inclusion in the packets, and we had a recommendation on agenda order,
we, the charter says there will be a rule established about this particular issue, about finance committee members who are non-voting residents. And therefore, the rules committee needs to make a recommendation to the town council as to what that rule should be. And the town council needs to adopt that rule. I would argue the town council does not need to adopt that rule tonight. I would argue that my report is very likely to say, since it isn't done yet, that the rules committee recommend that this, that the town council hear from, in addition to the rules vote, which I will have to report on, that they hear from OCA. And then they make a decision as to what the rules should be.
And that's why we're doing this, so that OCA has a statement to provide.
And it's interesting, you know, as Evan said, when we have one committee that is populated by members of another committee, then, and that committee is, you know, the committee in question, there's a conflict there, you know? So I don't know how to deal with that exactly. Anyway, I think we should vote.
You two in a very awkward position.
So Darcy could speak to why she abstained. I voted yes, and the reason I voted yes was obviously because I wanted to sell OCA down the river. No, the reason I voted yes was because it was clear I was going to be outvoted. And as a rules member, I could not, I didn't feel like I could argue, I wanted to argue for OCA from OCA's point of view. I didn't want to argue at rules from OCA's point of view. Unfortunately, I think finance committee members who were there argued from finance committee's point of view. So it's always, like you say, how do you do this? But from a rules standpoint, I was glad to hear that they were at least willing to not just make up their own process, but to adopt OCA's process, which of course they didn't know anything about because we luckily no one's really intending based on what we've been told by the president, et cetera, is that no one's expecting the non-resident, the resident non-voting members to be in place prior to July 1st.
Right.
So the timing is not critical. However, I would argue that if OCA does not weigh in on this and say, no, wait, stop, that in fact, it is just the finance committee, for all I know, is scheduling interviews right now.
Yeah. Right, I noticed they didn't put that, I was expecting that was gonna be in their revised charge, and it isn't for tonight. So let's have a motion.
Yeah, all right, so
you're cracking the whip today, I like it.
It currently includes recommendations of the town council regarding all appointments by the town council. Charter section 2.9 to clarify that non-voting resident members of the finance committee are not recommended to town council by OCA.
So we could either make that motion or we could try and make the opposite motion that says it stays the same, but I think it might actually be weirdly sensible to do this sort of, do the negative so that people understand exactly what we meant rather than saying, we vote to continue that our charge says what it says now, and they're like, well, what does that mean?
Okay.
So that's why I would.
So you just made that?
You made that motion, and I'll second it.
Okay.
And so, Phyllis, we do have a motion.
And you made it and seconded it?
Sarah made it.
I made it.
Sarah made it.
We have our own rules here.
Everyone else is making up their own rules, so.
That's right.
Might as well.
Yes.
Just get used to it.
And I was also told that the reason, I think the only other thing I can add is that when I said specifically the example of planning board appointing its own members or ZBA appointing its own members, I was told that this was also the reason this was a unicorn and separate from other things is because, in fact, these members were non-voting and that was somehow made it different.
Yeah. But that's good.
Okay.
So,
all those discussion.
In favor, taking okay, so all in favor.
The motion is to remove it from our charge.
It's to modify our charge.
Stop
saying that. I don't know if you've seen about that.
Modifying our charge to remove finance committee non-resident. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All right. All those in favor, say aye. Raise your hand. Okay. All those. So then I guess I should make a.
No, it's all those opposed.
Opposed.
So
unanimous.
It's 0-5 yes, it's weird to do it in kind of the negative like that, but it, that way it describes what it was. So, hey, we got done. We got something done.
I like this.
She is cracking the whip. You need to be the stacker.
All right, so my motion is
that job.
You got a date after?
To remove coordinating the annual review process of the town manager from his charge.
I move to retain coordination of the annual review the town manager annual review process within the OCA charge.
So you want to make it in that?
I move to retain the coordination of the annual review process, because you copied this directly from our charter, right? Process of the town manager within the OCA charge.
So this was a Lynn request.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I don't remember her rationale.
Well, I can try to make it, I think. The feeling is that the town manager affects, obviously, the entire council. This body is focused on a specific set of tasks, and she felt that it would be important to include, I think she had in mind chairs of other committees, rather than this particular body. In other words, to get greater diversity, greater input, a greater sense of the overall performance of the town manager. Obviously, the five of us do see him, but others on other committees, especially committee chairs, would see him in a different context. So I think that was her argument, that it would be, she would prefer, and I think it'd be better to have that diversity and scope that this committee could not provide for this particular task of town manager.
So
that
I think
was the, my understanding.
Go ahead.
I think it's a failure of understanding of what the words coordinate mean. It was never going to be these five people who were reviewing the town manager.
Mm-hmm.
It said coordinate.
Mm-hmm.
She wrote it, the annual review process of the town manager. And I said from the very first time she brought this up when we were sitting in the tiny Garabrant's room, that of course it made sense that the president would be affiliated with this. And of course it made, and whoever, we might come up with all sorts of levels of people. There could be a 360 review as part of it, et cetera.
Mm-hmm.
It was never going to be that the town manager evaluation was going to be written by these five people.
Mm-hmm.
It was going to be coordinated by this group, and I still think it belongs being coordinated by this group. I think there was also the comment at one point that it could be split off as an ad hoc thing.
Right.
And I totally disagree with that as the basic premise. I think the basic premise is coordination, and then as the time gets closer, entirely split off and ad hoc, just like to work on the goals for the town council, to work on the evaluation instrument, for example. Split off an ad hoc group to work on that so that all 13 don't have to work on it, so that all five of us don't work. But we're coordinating the process, not doing it all ourselves.
Right. And all 13 counselors are going to be doing evaluations anyway, so.
Well, under some people's opinion, that wouldn't happen. So that's one of the reasons I want this body to coordinate, so that we can have those discussions with whoever.
Right, yeah, I guess that hasn't been decided, but.
It seems obvious to some of us, but perhaps not all of us, that all 13 counselors would have some say.
Mm-hmm.
And so that doesn't mean that you couldn't have an ad hoc group of committee chairs that worked on one aspect of this, et cetera. So I move to retain the coordination of the annual review process of the town manager within the OCA charge. Alyssa moved. Who seconded?
I seconded.
I did.
Okay, Darcy seconded.
Yeah, seconded. She already
good.
Did.
All right.
All right, so all those in favor?
Well, we're through discussion, I guess. Is that it?
Is there any more to be said?
I have my reservations about this. I really think that this is something I would dearly love to hand off to a group and just let them worry about it for the entire year. We have enough to do. I don't feel strongly, coordinations, but that means we're ultimately responsible for making sure that this thing gets done. And I would prefer to have another group responsible for it, and we just don't have to worry about that particular task. It's this one particular task that's done every year and has to be done in a certain way, and it should involve a certain set group of people, And if every year we have to revisit it, okay, who gets to be on it this time? And is it this committee chair or that committee chair, da-da-da-da-da? You know, I mean, we can do it, and I guess we'll do it, but I have no problem with giving this to an ad hoc, call it what you will, but another body, of which maybe one or two of us will be members or maybe we won't, but, and that's their job and their responsibility, and they have to meet the deadlines and they have to do all the paperwork, blah, 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 blah. Because this is going to be, as you know, an enormously demanding task to be done right. So that's my only concern. I'm not going to die for it, but I don't have a problem with farming this off to somebody else.
I would ask that you hold on to all those concerns,
yeah.
And as we move along, mm-hmm. that you vote for my motion, and then as we move along,
no.
that you say, now I can see where we can carve pieces off of this, where this is not going to be our responsibility, where we are just going to set up, you know, this part of it, but the rest of it is going to be retained by other people. I can tell you for a fact
mm-hmm.
that what will happen if we don't retain some control
mm-hmm.
of this process
mm-hmm.
is we will have no control of this process, meaning the council will have no control of this process.
Mm-hmm.
A few individual members will have control of this process.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I want us to remain in a coordinating position
okay.
until we get further along. And then there might very well be a structure, like a decision tree,
right.
that makes sense that people could carry forward in years subsequent. But I think largely the first year we're going to have to get through it. And then see, because you're stuck with the old stuff that the town manager is being evaluated on, the select board evaluated, because you can't, you know, decide suddenly you're evaluating on other things this time. But then, for that whole process to unfold, that it may well be that next year at this time, George,
mm-hmm.
we're taking ourselves out of the process because it no longer needs to be coordinated by us, in theory, or some lesser amount of it does.
Mm-hmm.
But I hear what you're saying in terms of the workload, absolutely. But if we're assigning piece parts, I mean, I think we assign piece parts out, and that's what we can, or we ask the president to assign piece parts out to people or whatever. I just,
okay.
I am loath to let go of a group that has a huge, to me, has a huge stake in the town manager evaluation based on the appointments he brings us. The rest of the council, no matter what process we decide council-wide, the rest of the council will never know the town council, the town manager's appointment process as well as we do, and how effective or not effective we perceive that to be, I think, is a huge part of his evaluation.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I think it makes sense for us to carry it forward.
Well, that's what you people that are workload of this committee may not be a huge.
Once we get through more of the structural
after
once
we get
this
through June 30.
We'll never have to use this again. We'll never have to come up with another decision tree. Where, as far as I can tell, for outreach, the only thing do is help do forums
yeah.
and special hearings, which I don't want to do, and I think that what Paul said is that his staff actually should
yeah,
be
I right. kind of object to the way that was talked about in our report, in that
we're not
like the little sunshine club that's going and making
no.
the forums work for people.
No, well, I was
no.
just saying that's
yeah.
the only thing I could possibly see, but I have an argument. All right. Like, we don't have to do it.
Okay.
Like, we don't really
right.
have a big part in outreach. Yes.
But why don't you say, I agree with a lot of what George said, especially because I personally have no interest in being involved with them. That said, I would be incredibly hesitant to remove it from our charge without seeing a
what's
going to
take its place,
what
right.
it would be.
Right.
And it sounds like
right.
the president's argument at current is, I don't think it belongs in your committee, so take it out, and we'll figure out what it'll be like. And she has some ideas and she's expressed some of it, but
mm-hmm.
it's not a fully formed proposal.
Right. No,
and so I think for now, at least, we should say this stays in our committee. If you want to bring, if someone wants to bring forward a proposal of how we could better do a town manager evaluation, then we can look at it and we could say, you know what, we will remove this.
Mm-hmm.
But to remove it from our charge
right.
before knowing what it's going to be
right.
seems like a, I don't want to say dangerous, but it's a weird thing to do.
I like that.
We have a motion.
Seconded.
Seconded. So all in favor? Say
it's
aye.
All a work in progress.
All right.
Wait a minute.
It's to retain. The motion is to retain.
To retain. Okay.
To retain.
Okay.
For now.
For now.
Okay.
All right. Then Evan has a
meeting. Yeah. Sorry. I gotta run.
Okay. We got it all done.
Yeah. It's because you were pushing.
I know. It looked scarier
yeah,
when I saw the four votes were just described two different ways. So the four bullet points are just descriptions of taking it out, voting,
so
taking it out, voting. Yes, we'll work So are you guys gonna go ahead? You have, you technically have a committee meeting that, and I will just put this aside. I can be a visitor at your committee if I don't talk. How's that? So we, so that the minutes of the next. So we have to adjourn at what time? I move to adjourn.
11:17.
11:17. Thank you, Evan, for straightening us out.
I will see you all.
On how to describe the thing.
Way too soon.
Yes. Okay, so we adjourned at 11:17, and now you're gonna have your 11 o'clock meeting in case the hordes of public want to come in for your 11 o'clock meeting.
I called the, our subcommittee, outreach and communications, to order at 11:18.
And you, you're the three people who are.
It's actually everyone but me.
He's absent.
It's actually.
Oh, so it's four people on the subcommittee, okay.
Yes, and Evan's absent, so it's actually three with one absent.
And one visitor then.
And one per member of the public, that's right.
Okay.
Do we have an agenda?
Yes, we do. She has an agenda somewhere.
On the post.
It's in the packet.
Okay.
Somewhere, but I have to find the right packet.
Could you try and email that to me? If there's an agenda.
And so this is gonna be just a lot shorter than.
Oh, could I be excused for a moment?
Sure, just go ahead.
Okay. It's in the meeting packets.
Actually, what's there, actually, I don't see an agenda. I just see I just see the posting.
The posting agenda?
The posting is there.
It's basically the same.
Yeah, right, I see. Okay, the posting is there. That's all that's in the file for this subcommittee. It's just the posting. And.
Where do I find the subcommittee minutes?
Subcommittee minutes.
I mean, subcommittee, oh, outreach subcommittee. I get it.
Yeah.
No, that's outreach subcommittee minutes, 2 days ago.
Should be there, should be yours truly. Yeah, there it is.
Oh.
That should be there.
But why would I want the minutes?
Well, just to tell you what we did last time.
Oh, okay.
You're gonna have to prove that at some point, right?
And it's pretty much a blow, it was pretty much, it was an open discussion. People just talking back and forth. I caught some of it, but not all of it by any means. And there was no formal decisions made, and we just agreed to meet again today.
So my takeaway, because I wrote this in the report.
Yep.
My takeaway from the discussion that we had with Paul and the three participation officers is that we do not work with either group. I think I wrote, if you've read my report, I wrote what the things are and are not that the community participation officers do. And so one of the things in our charge was district meetings,
mm-hmm.
right? So that's the purview now of not us, but actually of the community participation officers, and they've written it all out. They have put themselves in as it helping to get rooms together, to get any supporting materials together. So I wrote that in my report. So it's, you know, how to plan for a subcommittee or ad hoc meeting, check. How to plan for a district meeting or office hours, check. They also made it very clear that their outreach is for bringing in volunteers and nominees or candidates for town manager appointments only, not for town council appointments.
Mm-hmm.
So it could be, so it would be brought up that one of our charges is to do outreach to bring in people for town council.
Just the finance committee? That would only be finance committee, right? For residents?
Oh, well, we're also appointing planning board.
Oh, planning board is a zone of appeals, yes.
Just
for Never mind.
Ranked choice voting.
Yeah.
Right. So there are other areas we could, in theory.
So, but then to me, it has also been said that it's all the counselors that are on the front line, right? It was not, the way that the town manager, community participation, and OCA as a body that necessarily, you know, coordinated or did these things on their own, but that it was the responsibility of all counselors on the front line to do this regroup. So we could talk about that. What exactly would our role be in doing separate recruiting and outreach for the, what, five boards and committees that we're in charge of, the town council has? So what would that look like? Would we then do similar things to what the community participation officers are doing? If they go to an event, then we make sure that OCA goes to the event and gets names.
So somewhere you saw specifically that the CPOs are not...
They mentioned it. They said.
Oh.
I believe it was Jen. It's in your minutes.
Oh.
Said that their purview is for...
Town manager appointed.
Town manager appointed only. They do not have any power.
Oh, they use the word only?
Yes.
I missed that.
Yeah.
Can I just see what's the general, this general overall topic?
It's outreach.
Outreach and communications. What's our role?
Outreach, what's your role? Okay.
Do you think that it would be helpful for us to set up regular meeting times, regular times for them to come to our meeting?
We asked that and they said no, thank you.
Oh.
Didn't, well, Paul came to what, our last meeting? One meeting with us. With two of them.
How do you get to know greeting session, right?
Right.
But no agreement or no sense that on every other week or every, I mean, you could
we
do it once
them.
A month.
So once a month.
We could ask them. We could ask them once a month.
We did ask them that,
yeah.
But we could ask again.
Yeah.
But we asked that at our last subcommittee meeting, and they said no. We don't see that as part of their role. But I can ask if I can extend the invitation again.
You mean coming to being, if we invited them just to come and report on what they've been up to, they didn't feel like that was something that they wanted to
do. I mean, they don't really want to do regular. If there's something that we want to ask them in particular, absolutely.
Well, we just
but they
once
don't
a
feel
month
like
for a half an hour.
Touch base and see what they're
to.
Up to. Yeah. I mean, who else is overseeing what they're doing?
So they're seeing themselves as their authority as a town manager.
Okay.
Well, I think that we need to be, you know, like encouraging us to all be more holistic, you know, to be working together with them cooperatively, and I have attended the last two meetings of the Resident Advisory Committee,
mm-hmm.
And I think that's actually a fairly good idea. If they meet, it might be nice for one of us to go to their meetings if we could get ourselves invited, just because it's just good to maintain a good relationship, you know? I think it was Jennifer came to my district meeting on Thursday,
right.
And that added so much to it. You know, she really was able to answer a lot of the questions, and she was just a very good kind of bridge, I felt, at the meeting. And so I think we need to really try to.
So would you, as an action item, do you want to have one of us suggest what, that ask if we can have one of our members regularly go to their meetings, and then do you want to suggest a schedule in which they come and just check in with us? So what would you want to do?
Yeah, like maybe, you know, our first meeting of the month or something, or whatever, to make it easy so they know when it is to come and come to this little meeting.
And they're coming here to just tell us what they've been up to for the last month.
Yeah, and figure out ways that we can work together, you know, how we can help them, how they can help us.
And Sarah's expressed some reservation, or at least a thought, that there might be a tension between them reporting to the town manager, who is their boss, and them reporting to us. And they might feel uneasy as to, you know, we're not giving them marching orders, we're not telling them what to do, we're not their boss, we don't oversee them,
right.
That's correct, but we are sort of, we'd like to know what success they've had and what outreach they've been doing, and as a courtesy to us, we would appreciate that once a month, is what we're basically asking for them.
Yeah,
and if they
yeah.
have an objection to that, I guess they'll tell us, but the hope is they wouldn't, but so so we'd ask them like once a month just to check in with us as a courtesy.
Mm-hmm. And I guess if we could have a liaison, but it won't use our, or one of us could just attend their meetings if they were.
And their meetings being the RAC?
No, the Community Participation Officers.
Oh, Lordy. They have meetings too?
Yeah.
Count me out on that one, okay. I mean, I'm happy to hear, I'm happy to have them report to me, but I have no desire to sit.
They haven't invited us to their meeting, but I have gone, the RAC meetings, they're post, regularly posted meetings.
Yes, that's right, exactly. I think we don't need to attend CPO meetings. I think, no, it's just the RAC.
All right, so the RAC, if possible, very clearly, I mean, so is the RAC that you want me to reach out to?
What is RAC?
Resident Advisory Committee.
Resident Advisory Council.
Which is appointed by Paul, and they work closely. He works with them individually really more than as a committee, I think, is what his sense was, I got from listening to him.
Yeah, he doesn't feel like they have anything to do with us.
Yeah.
But if you want him to state that again, I'll reach out to them and then make sure that that's how they feel. But that's my understanding, is the Resident Advisory Committee does not have anything to do with us. But I will try to make that a fact, if it is or it isn't.
Well, you know, it seems like we should be working toward, you know, working more in collaboration and cooperation with the town manager.
I agree.
So, I would like to have connections with both of those bodies, and I think that that it can only help. I think that, you know, we just have to have more communication, I think.
So, I agree. What I believe that we pose that to Paul and about the Resident Advisory Committee and to the CPOs at the last meeting, and it's my opinion was they said no thank you. I will ask again.
Hmm.
And if there's something that you feel would be more inviting, or I'll send you the email, you guys an email first. You can individually, of course we can't discuss or debate or deliberate today.
Just think all the training we can offer to people on SharePoint.
Right,
in the
we can make a living.
Step one, delete it. Use Google Docs.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so now interview.
Now you're in there, kiddo. I can see your little flag. Uh oh. Danger, danger.
Danger.
All right.
So now delete that line.
Did it show up?
Yes.
Yes.
It did.
Now there are only four items there.
And
two members of
OCA.
Should be one.
Right.
OCA designee.
OCA designee.
OCA designee. Is that what you called it in the vote? Yes.
That's right.
Oh,
OCA
I thought we said chair.
No.
No. It could be. We could change it. It can be anyone.
We
but
voted
one.
To
vote.
Make to designate the chair.
Chair, but it could, we could.
What?
Right. OCA designee.
You're explaining it to me right now.
Yes. Right.
It's the OCA designee, which in this case, so the process is OCA designee, and you recently voted that OCA designee was the chair.
Sure.
Whereas in future,
they
that
could
OCA
say,
designee
could
might
be
somebody
right,
else.
Right.
George.
And so we voted that the chair should just be for this process?
For the time being.
For the time being, but we could in theory change that.
Anytime we want.
If our chair comes back and says, I don't want to do this.
So I'm going to say this.
I had to have, because you're going to be busy.
Yeah, no.
You got the numbers from Paul about how many people have applied?
Yeah.
It's a lot.
Yeah.
Well, could have been more.
And
it's
right
more than I expected.
Wait, when did we find out this number?
I asked Paul personally.
Jesus, what is this thing called process around here?
But he had said he had already told Sarah.
So
let
me just make something, I need to reel this back in. So
yeah.
I'm not saying, believe it or not, I'm not saying I'm right. I'm saying we need to make thoughtful decisions when we say things like this. So. In the past, it has always been true that we never told anyone how many people applied for a particular thing.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as we say that, you're now going to have the newspaper calling up Paul and saying, how many people applied for finance committee? And then he'll tell the newspaper, but he won't have told the entire town council.
Mm.
This is not a good position to be in. I just reminded him a couple of meetings ago that, because Margaret didn't know that because nobody bothered to tell her, that we don't release the number of people who've applied for committees until
we figure out the as yet undetermined demographic method of reporting, where the town manager says, these are the three names I'm giving you, there were 25 names altogether, and X amount of them identified this particular way. If we start doing this way, then it's going to be a free-for-all. So we need to think about if we're going to continue that, because it's not new, it would be a continuation of a new thing. But if we're just going to say, oh, who cares, tell the newspaper every time they call how many people applied, that feels really uneasy to me, because that telling the newspaper is not telling the council. And I think if anything, the council should know more than the newspaper knows.
So the council should know before the newspaper knows.
Right, and the way the council would find out is by getting the demographic report from either this body, because we're putting forward names for planning board, and we're saying there were X number of applicants, here are the names we're recommending, and here's how people identified in that pool, but without all their names. That's when they get that information, is when we're making the recommendation, not now.
I don't think the desire for the number was motivated by any, it's just, we just were curious.
I asked them specifically because I was like, we need a timeline, and
just practice.
That gives you a
sense of
how many
interviews
you need.
Right. We have cushion if you come back and you say, the only people who have applied for ZBA are those currently on the ZBA.
Right. I'm asking personally, just don't report what the number is.
Okay.
Because we're on camera. And don't report it to the rest of the town council either, because we're not ready for that yet. But that will be part of our report.
So we can
to the council.
Secretly pass a note around among us.
No, because then it would be a public document.
Now,
and then,
yes.
Then you've just now created a
but
public document.
But you could ask me after this meeting, Christopher.
But you shouldn't. Because the only reason you're finding that out is to help us understand the interview process. Because
how
we
much
should
time
not
we need
be
for
in a position of knowing that yet as a group. Just as you apparently voted, right, when I wasn't here, that you didn't want to see the CAFs until after you firmed up
that's
the questions.
That's correct.
And
yes.
So, you know, we're staying. Trying to keep the wall there,
okay.
You know, and then take it down brick by brick, I suppose, as we get further along in the process.
So, interview protocol.
So, OCA designee.
Who may at their discretion.
I made that
include,
change.
Right, town manager, committee chair, staff liaison.
Process diagram.
Yes.
Adopted.
Okay. All right.
Am I just doing something like right here that nobody else can see either? But I'm putting in number three.
You're probably in the wrong. If you have to be in today's agenda packet.
My tab says injury protocol draft.
Sarah, you're not on this document.
I'm not?
No.
Okay, during posted meeting 02-2519 and 0419.
There's still a newer version.
In
the title,
today's meeting packet.
The title has to have.
It is in today's meeting.
I'll be right back. We are having so much fun.
Oh, God, this is awful.
All right, well, I guess I'll find
no,
it.
No, you'll after. Find it. No. What?
We're worried about
I'm walking down camera.
Multiple member body committee chair.
I don't know how we could thank you for attempting to take minutes for such a meeting.
I can do so.
I bet too. I hope so.
These people, as I was telling Paul that I do this, people repeat themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So you only have to say it once.
Yep.
And that eliminates a whole page.
That's true.
So who wrote multiple member body committee chair?
You're in the wrong room.
I'm sorry?
Who wrote multiple member body committee chair? It's a purple flag.
It is Alyssa.
Alyssa. I just think committee chair is fine.
George.
All right, doesn't matter. Next.
How long do you want to argue that?
Exactly. Not long. Trust me, not long.
Yeah, was the length of the minutes that I sent, was that okay? Did I cover everything?
Yeah. One thing I discovered in reading the lawyer's report on the open meeting law.
You're there.
I'm
sorry. Go ahead.
No,
she
seemed to be saying we shouldn't be sending minutes around for people to review.
I thought that was garbage.
Well, that's
what
she
really
said.
That doesn't make sense, but
that's
yes. Because there's a chance of an expression of opinion, except minutes aren't supposed to be expressions
right.
of opinion. They're supposed
they're
to be
poorly written
just
facts.
A record of what was transpired.
I hear you.
All right, so you inserted multiple member body committee chair.
Yes, because it's like committee chair of what? I know, but it, but, and we can rephrase it. You can come up with a better phrase. What I'm trying to say is, no, but the committee, what committee chair?
Any
the OCA committee chair?
Whatever. Any free committee chair.
Town committees.
Relevant committee chair?
In the town, right.
You'd say relevant committee chair, you know, appropriate.
So, under OCA, where it says, under who is present?
At your discretion, the designee may include town manager, if available, relevant committee chair, or just, I mean, I don't care.
Okay, if you like that better, I'm fine with that. I'll change it.
You know, relevant committee chair, or just committee chair. I mean, you know, I mean, it's pretty obvious. It would be the committee that we're dealing with.
No, that's why I changed it, because it's not that obvious. You'd be surprised. Just like on charge documents, I don't like when they say later in the charge, committee, because I want to be able to copy and paste, and I want it to say finance committee, and I want it to say whatever committee.
Change that.
Exactly. I got something I wanted. It's so exciting.
All right, okay. Anything else?
So, OCA designee who may at their discretion include relevant committee chair, if available, town manager, if available, staff liaison, if available.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, next. Roman three. All members of the interview team need to follow this protocol, not just OCA designee.
So that needs to change because
There are all members.
Interview protocol for OCA designee.
Designee. That's right.
Because there's no one else.
That's right. So, any thought here? We gotta get, number two needs to be edited.
Yeah.
The first one I think is okay. Does time commitment, homework required, when committee meets. So, maybe leave it at that. And drop everything after committee meets.
Okay. How do I want to phrase the fact that, okay, so most of these questions are, have you had any experience? They're mostly questions the OCA designee is going to ask.
Mm-hmm.
But the second one is to require that the committee chair or staff liaison do something. What if none of those people are there? How can we effectively describe, in less words than I would normally use, George, that says, why don't we just say, describe what committee does? Why don't we just do that? So why don't we just take all that out?
Say
who's doing it, describe what committee does, time commitment, homework required, when the committee meets, and major issues coming up without being leading, which we'll figure out a way to phrase. But that way, this is the OCA designee is doing this, or the OCA designee is turning to Nate Malloy, who happens to be sitting there.
Right,
or if Nate Malloy's not there, you know, then maybe the town manager
good.
Will
rather than assigning roles.
Or the OCA designee will have had to do a bunch more homework because they know that
so
they're not going to
the
have any backup.
Somewhere it seems like
the charge will help. We should mention
that the
documents charge.
That they should have there available.
That
the
is
charge.
A very good point.
The
that should be specifically.
Any other relevant committee documents?
Do we need to spell that out?
I think the charge, and like, I don't know, like, say if it was the housing committee and the housing production plan was hot off the press, I suppose you could end on that. But I mean, these are only 20-minute interviews. They didn't have a lot of time.
Right,
so,
well, the charge at the very least.
But so.
But here we're trying to tell the designee how to
right.
do
so,
that. I mean, this is getting into the weeds,
the
isn't it?
Charge.
Really? Okay.
To the applicant. This partly reflects back to the conversation that we had before about kind of quizzing them as to, like, do you have any idea what you're applying for? And have you ever been to any meetings, et cetera? So provide the charge to the applicant. Describe what the committee does.
Didn't they get the charge earlier?
Yeah, it seems a little late for them.
Like in 1-5?
Okay. All right. Contact those interested to set up interview.
And provide.
Provide a copy of the charge. And any other relevant documents.
Unless this is, again, going back to your little test of, like, do you actually know this committee that you apply for?
Right. But you could provide a copy of the charge and a link to the webpage, and they could be like, oh, good, I forgot to look at that. Or, yeah. And so we're
no,
helping them.
I think
them.
It's good.
So we're helping
them.
Fair enough.
So,
okay. So put it up in file. Good.
Describe.
And remove two.
Based.
Three, two.
Okay. charge and others. We're gonna change this again, but you're gonna see where I'm going with it, so. And you're gonna fix it for me. So you're gonna wanna bring a copy of the charge with you anyway to the meeting. That's the other thing, is it's one thing to email it to the person, but you're not gonna be sitting there in your 20-minute interview trying to pull up the charge on your phone.
Right.
So you're gonna walk in, when you walk in, you're gonna have a copy of their CAF and you're gonna have a copy of their charge, of the committee charge.
Okay.
CAF and charge on the table. Okay, so then we can just change it to describe what committee.
Describe what committee does, time commitment.
There we go, go back to that, because I just said that there's already a CAF and charge on the table. This person's, like, is it clear that it's that person's CAF, not everybody's CAF?
Yes, it is, okay, let's go.
I was gonna make sure that describing the, what the committee does, blah, 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 is actually done by the chair of the relevant committee.
The reason that I didn't write it there, I'm sorry, I was babbling about that earlier when we were trying to fix something, is that the reason we don't write that there is because if it turns out that they're not there.
Okay.
So they bail or something happens.
They're not available, whatever.
And no, like, literally, it's, it could be just you.
Right, you have to, you gotta do.
It could be just you, in which case you'd be like, oh shit, I expected them to tell me this. So hopefully they would give you enough notice that they could tell you what they would have said. Okay, so how do we, say the major, because people liked the idea of major issues coming up, but then didn't like the idea of making it so, say it was back in the day when One East Pleasant Street was coming up, right? We wanted to be like, do you have any idea that One East Pleasant Street is happening, but on the other hand, we don't want you to try and commit to what you think about One East Pleasant Street, because you're the committee has to decide that,
yes,
not you.
Can I interrupt for a minute? I know this is, we need to finish this, but I know that we have other votes that we were going to take today.
Yeah.
We just want to make sure that we have enough time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So,
what were the votes?
So,
looking back at our agenda.
At 11.
Pardon?
Are you having your other meeting at 11?
Yeah, I'm just thinking that we, I don't think we have much to discuss, but
yeah.
I almost feel like
I don't have to leave
presidents.
At 11, but I have a meeting with Kev at
11:45
that I'm running, so
latest
11:15.
So are the votes you're referring to, Darcy, the thing under consider change to our charge? Or
yeah.
Were there other? Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
Good, that's four. I'm thinking,
so
please, there's enough.
Yeah,
okay.
The only two votes that I did is changing our charge to take out finance committee as something that we...
So these are proposals that were not necessarily, in fact, none of which were proposed by this committee. These are all proposed by the president who wrote the charge in the first place.
Right.
Okay.
But did I make that clear? I'm not sure if I made that clear.
Well, when you say we're taking votes, it's like, I mean, there's always the question of, like, why do we want to do this? Because we're trying to be responsive to the president's concerns. Is that my understanding?
Yes.
As opposed to this was
so
any of our
I've
idea.
Never written a report before. So in the report that I wrote, I believe I just put the vote in because I thought that was what you're supposed to do it and then put what prompted it, but if somebody would like to change that for me, like if you would like to put something else in, I'm open. I just have never done, this is my first baby.
I'm not complaining, Sarah. I'm just trying to understand.
No, but I mean, like, if there's, I don't know how to do it, so if there's something you're like, this is what is expected to be on a report, I would love to learn, because I don't want to do it the wrong way.
We're making it up. We are literally making
but
it
so
up
if
as
there's
we
a
go.
Suggestion you want to make as to how the vote should be said, or the motion should be reflected, or it should be reflected differently in my report, then we can do that as well. I believe I did say that it was because we were asked by the president at our past meeting if we would do it.
I was just looking at two separate documents. I was looking at our agenda versus the report draft. And the report draft makes that clear.
How do we want to go forward to accomplish whatever we have remaining before
11:15?
Okay, 11:15.
So we have to 11:15. So we'll just try to do the best we can with it, I guess. I guess we're skipping over.
So we're going to put the interview protocol aside for now.
Okay.
And we're gonna come to, what we should be looking at, Sarah, it sounds like from what you said, is we should be looking at the actual report, the draft report, more so than, and perhaps side by side with the agenda for today. That's closed.
I'm pretty sure that I put in the same way, but I have now not picked up.
Yeah, so we're just, that's fine. And we're trying to do things side by side and rearrange all this. Okay, so technical difficulties are a huge waste of time. Not our fault. So finance committee.
Right.
Is this in today's posting?
I believe it is.
Yes, it is.
I'm not talking about the agenda, I'm talking about the posting.
Posting, yeah, I believe it is.
Taking resident appointments to finance committee out of our charge. Yes, thank you. So, I'm in this awkward position because I'm on rules, and so is Darcy. Mm-hmm. And this was referred to rules by the council,
yeah,
as you'll recall. And then the idea was that rules would get a crack at it first, and then I thought the idea was then OCA would get a crack at it. But so rules did talk about this, then I got sick, various things happened, and no mention was made of it during the town council meeting that was like 10 days later,
right,
after that meeting, so it was never discussed.
Right.
However, it was reported by some rules members who are on the finance committee to the finance committee, and also by the president, who was there for the rules meeting and at the finance committee meeting, because she's part of the finance committee, what was discussed at rules. So the finance committee knows more about what happened than this body does.
Awesome.
Yes, so that did not work out right. So that did not work out right. So also, that written report has not yet been finished by me, which is supposed to be in tonight's packet for the entire town council, reporting out what we decided, which was, maybe Darcy could say it faster than I could.
We decided that the finance committee could do the finance committee would take from OCA the responsibility of interviewing candidates for the resident, non-voting residents of the finance committee, and of then choosing them, bringing them back to the finance committee to choose. In other words, they would set up a process. They said they would base it on our process, but that they would basically take that piece away from our responsibilities and do it themselves.
So I had heard that, and I actually spoke to that when Lynn asked me in our goals, the goals for the town council meeting, whether or not we addressed either of these things, and so it was brought up that that had been proposed. My feeling was only this, that it was in our charge, it was written in our charge, we had it in our charge. I realize that another committee can take this away from us because of the process that's been put forward. I simply wanted to say, here's what's been proposed. I would just like us to weigh in on it, even though it may not matter. I just wanted to have us weigh in on how we felt about it. That may or may not be appropriate. Yes,
Evan. So, I have lots to say, but I'll try and keep it brief. So first thing is, it's not in our charge. Like, it doesn't specifically say residents to finance committee. So there's nothing to take. So I guess I'm a little curious because the wording of this is vote on taking resident appointments to finance committee out of our charge, but there's nothing.
Our charge, if you, right, you headed up, right?
Take out of our charge.
Technically doesn't say.
It says make recommendations to the town council regarding all appointments by the town council. So we're not taking anything out. Are you saying we're voting to add to it that says except for?
Except that those were appointments of the president.
No, what I'm saying, we're not taking anything out of our charge. We're adding language to the charge that says except for. Correct?
Well,
is that what we're looking to do right now?
Well, wait. So if, I mean, Sarah wrote up just like a way to phrase the vote, not an opinion as to whether
right.
or not that should be the vote. Right, in her report for tonight. So, for example, it says, Outreach Communication Appointment Committee voted on 4-1 to or not to remove from its charge recommendation regarding resident appointments to Finance Committee. You're right that it doesn't say we should alter that phrasing in the report.
There's nothing
that
to take
references
out of the charge.
Town council appointments, which we currently believe the resident members to be town council appointments. And if they're town council appointments, then they belong to us. They are belong to us.
So we're not arguing to take anything out of our charge. We're actually arguing to add language to our charge to take something out of our
The only person who's arguing that is
no. That's with the
committee or
right. I'm talking specifically about this language here.
Yeah. So we're gonna fix that.
Right. Okay. Because you can't remove something that's not there.
Right.
That's my first thing. If we do approve this, we're actually adding to the charge. We're not removing anything from the charge.
No. Wait. Okay. The charge.
There's
right
nothing
now,
to remove from the charge.
Well, there is if we agree with rules.
Yes. What looking at this charge, what are we actually going to remove?
We make recommendations to town council regarding all appointments by the town council.
Right.
That's what we currently do. If we agree that finance committee should take that away from us, then we need to change our charge. If we don't agree, we don't need to change anything.
To what though? Is what I'm saying. We're not removing any language from the charge, we're adding language.
If we agreed with them, we would change the charge and say, make recommendations to the town council regarding all appointments by the town council, except for.
Right. So I'm saying we're not removing anything, any language from the charge, we're adding language to the charge if we agree with them.
Well, okay, yes, it's just a different way.
I'm sorry, I realize
yes.
We're saying the same thing, but we're on different pages.
Different ways. Yes, I get it now. Okay.
I'm talking about the physical language in our charge, right? Right.
Right.
I'm saying if we approve this, we're editing the charge not to remove anything, but to add language that specifies.
Okay.
Okay. So that was that was more confusing than I needed to make it.
That's true. Recommendations to the town council regarding all. Okay. So instead of that, it should say regarding all. Point. I know I should be copying and pasting, but God knows I can't get
so,
all the
so what should the motion be then?
By
we're
the council section 2.9. So the question is whether or not recommendations to the towns to modify, it would be to modify, if we were agreeing to do this, which no one is saying that we are at this point, is to modify. I'm working on Sarah's report right now. If you're trying to follow along,
right.
Modify its charge recommendation to the town council regarding all. The wording's bad, but it's currently says regarding all appointments to the town council. To clarify, I'm just making this up. To clarify that non-voting resident members, I pick up the language from the actual thing, are not recommended by the OCA. It's rough, but that's the general idea, is that it says the charge currently says all appointments by the town council. We're saying if we agree with what rules agreed to and what the finance committee seems to want, that we, OCA, would say, well, if you're going to if we agree with you there, we would clarify that statement in our charge to say non-voting resident members of the finance committee are not recommended by the OCA, but by the finance committee. Or we could just say it's just not ours,
right.
And then wherever
okay.
they go,
so how do we
that,
feel about this?
Okay.
Is there a motion first?
The motion hasn't been made.
No
of this
okay.
just
okay.
been
okay.
drafted so that we at
yeah.
least know what we're arguing about.
Right. That's what I was so with respect to colleagues who are on the Rules Committee, this strikes me as really strange to make Finance the only committee in our entire town and council that decides its own members to appoint.
Mm-hmm.
I am also, and I don't know the details of this. This is the problem with everything, right? Is I wasn't there, so I don't know the discussion. So forgive me if I'm just saying things that you all already debated. But it seems to me very strange that Finance Committee would choose its own members, which is a luxury that we give. I would actually love to say, Mark Parent, you're in charge.
Yeah.
You choose your new ZBA members, and then
right.
you don't have to do any interviews, and you can take a
why
nap, right?
Why don't we?
And so,
yeah.
to me, it's a really strange thing.
Yes.
I also think it's interesting. There's also a level of curiosity I have about the debate, given that two of the members of the Rules Committee are on finance.
Oh.
three? Is it
three?
Two.
Two are on finance.
But I
plus
have a
the
feeling
president
Lynn was probably at the
us.
Meeting.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah, she was.
So, who also, so the president, this is a recommendation from the president who also serves on finance, and so that seems to me an interesting dynamic.
Interesting dynamic. Let's go with that. Yes.
I'm not quite sure why this makes any sense
right.
at all,
right.
and why if we are charged with appointments to the town council that we would make a special carve out
mm-hmm.
for finance committee. It seems to make this committee,
yeah.
it gives this committee a strange status that we are giving to no other
right.
committee. So I personally would love a good rationale for why this committee should be treated with such luxury.
So I was told by our president and by members of the finance committee that finance is a very special committee that has to have very special qualifications and that...
Unlike ZBA.
So just listen to me because...
I know, I'm hearing you. I'm sorry. I don't mean to talk over you.
That only people who have served on finance committee would be able to figure out who is qualified to be on finance committee. My argument was the same as yours, was that I believe the planning board and zoning board are very special committees
mm-hmm.
that have very special
mm-hmm.
qualifications. So what would then be the difference? And if you're going to change this charge, what makes me think you're not going to then come and say, or that we should, if you're looking at consistency, say, planning board, guess what? Your chair gets to, you guys get to pick because you have special qualifications. Zoning is definitely the same, I think the same way, very specific in its qualifications. So I can't answer that. I struggle with the exact same question. And I have posed that question, and what has come back to me is plans to be special.
Okay.
This seems to be the argument.
We need to make a motion because we have another vote.
Okay.
Three more,
they
don't
have language that they feel is
so it would be I think somebody help me out here to modify its committee charge to modify
it's modify
the charge that currently specifies recommendations to the town. OCA makes recommendations to the town council regarding all appointments by the town council, charter section 2.9, to clarify that non-voting resident members of the finance committee are not recommended to the town council by
Did
the OCA.
Repeat of double
A, no, it's like wicked awkward.
We have to fix this, and then
yes.
we can always just email the language.
Yeah.
Okay.
To modify.
Yeah.
But at the moment,
the
we're not
OCA
hearing
the committee charge that currently, because that's what we're trying to show, is that it's a change that currently includes recommendations to the town council regarding all appointments by the town council charter, to clarify that non-voting resident members of the finance committee are not recommended to the town council by the OCA.
What if we simply don't act on this?
That it gets taken away
from us. If we just,
we
why do we worry about worrying this since nobody, I mean, just
I
if we decide
well,
not to act on it,
so
we, nothing happens.
Right.
No, they're going to go ahead and just do it.
Is this, can I ask you a question?
No, they can't. We have the charge. The charge says we have control.
Oh.
So if we don't.
Can I ask a question to rules people? Is this being brought forward separate from the rules package for town council to vote on? Or will this be brought forward as part of an overall rules package that we vote on?
So. The timing is such that this needs to be decided before the package gets brought forward. So just like we had a recommendation on form of address, and we had a recommendation on public comment inclusion in the packets, and we had a recommendation on agenda order,
the charter says there will be a rule established about this particular issue, about finance committee members who are non-voting residents. And therefore, the rules committee needs to make a recommendation to the town council as to what that rule should be. And the town council needs to adopt that rule. I would argue the town council does not need to adopt that rule tonight. I would argue that my report is very likely to say, since it isn't done yet, that the rules committee recommend that this, that the town council hear from, in addition to the rules vote, which I will have to report on, that they hear from OCA. And then they make a decision as to what the rules should be.
And that's why we're doing this, so that OCA has a statement to provide.
And it's interesting, you know, as Evan said, when we have one committee that is populated by members of another committee, then, and that committee is, you know, the committee in question, there's a conflict there, you know? So I don't know how to deal with that exactly. But anyway, I think we should vote.
You two in a very awkward position.
So Darcy could speak to why she abstained. I voted yes, and the reason I voted yes was obviously because I wanted to sell OCA down the river. No, the reason I voted yes was because it was clear I was going to be outvoted.
Mm-hmm.
And as a rules member, I could not, I didn't feel like I could argue, I wanted to argue for OCA from OCA's point of view. I didn't want to argue at rules from OCA's point of view. Unfortunately, I think finance committee members who were there argued from finance committee's point of view. So it's always, like you say, how do you do this? But from a rules standpoint, I was glad to hear that they were at least willing to not just make up their own process, but to adopt OCA's process, which of course they didn't know anything about because we luckily no one's really intending based on what we've been told by the president, et cetera, is that no one's expecting the resident non-voting members to be in place prior to July 1st.
Right.
So the timing is not critical. However, I would argue that if OCA does not weigh in on this and say, no, wait, stop, that in fact, it is just the finance committee, for all I know, is scheduling interviews right now.
Yeah. Right, I noticed they didn't put that, I was expecting that was going to be in their revised charge, and it isn't for tonight. So let's have a motion.
Yeah, all right, so
you're cracking the whip today. I like it.
The meeting charge currently includes recommendations of the town council regarding all appointments by the town council. Charter section 2.9 to clarify that non-voting resident members of the finance committee are not recommended to town council by OCA.
So we could either make that motion or we could try and make the opposite motion that says it stays the same, but I think it might actually be weirdly sensible to do this sort of do the negative so that people understand exactly what we meant rather than saying, we vote to continue that our charge says what it says now, and they're like, well, what does that mean?
Right.
So that's why I would...
So you just made that...
You made that motion, and I'll second it.
Okay.
And so, Phyllis, we do have a motion.
And you made it and seconded it?
Sarah made it.
I made it.
Sarah made it.
We have our own rules here.
Everyone else is making up their own rules, so...
That's right.
Might as well.
Yes.
Just get used to it.
And I was also told that the reason, I think the only other thing I can add is that when I said specifically the example of planning board appointing its own members or ZBA appointing its own members, I was told that this was also the reason this was a unicorn and separate from other things is because, in fact, these members were non-voting and that somehow made it different.
Yeah. Wait, that's okay, so all those in favor are taking it. Okay, so all in favor.
The motion is to remove it from our charge.
To modify our charge.
Stop
saying your mouth. Like, I don't know what you mean.
Modifying our charge to remove finance committee non-resident. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All right. All those in favor, say aye. Raise your hand. Okay. All those. So then I guess I should make a...
No, it's all those opposed.
Opposed.
So.
Ooh, unanimous.
It's a 0-5 vote. But yes, it's weird. It's weird to do it in kind of the negative like that. But it,
okay.
That way, it describes what it was.
You have another
so
vote.
Hey, we got time. We got something done.
I like this.
She is cracking the whip. Yeah. Used to be the stacker.
All right, so the final
that job.
You got a date after?
Remove coordinating the annual review process of the town manager from his charge.
Just
I move to retain coordination of the annual review the town manager annual review process within the OCA charge.
So you want to make it in that?
I
second.
Move
change
to
change
retain
it.
The the coordination of the annual review process, because you copied this directly from our charge, right? Process of the town manager within the OCA charge.
So this was a Lynn request.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I don't remember her rationale.
Well, I can try to make it, I think. The feeling is that the town manager affects obviously the entire council. This body is focused on a specific set of tasks, and she felt that it would be important to include, I think she had in mind chairs of other committees, rather than this particular body. In other words, to get greater diversity, greater input, a greater sense of the overall performance of the town manager. Obviously, the five of us do see him, but others on other committees, especially committee chairs, would see him in a different context. So I think that was her argument, that it would be, she would prefer and think it would be better to have that diversity and scope that this committee could not provide for this particular task of town manager.
So
that
I think
that my understanding.
Go ahead.
I think it's a failure of understanding of what the words
coordinate
mean. It was never going to be these five people who were reviewing the town manager.
Mm-hmm.
It said coordinate.
Mm-hmm.
She wrote it. The annual review process of the town manager. And I said from the very first time she brought this up when we were sitting in the tiny Garibrandt's room that of course it made sense that the president would be affiliated with this. And of course it made, and whoever, we might come up with all sorts of levels of people. There could be a 360 review as part of it, et cetera.
Mm-hmm.
It was never going to be that the town manager evaluation was going to be written by these five people.
Mm-hmm.
It was going to be coordinated by this group, and I still think it belongs being coordinated by this group. I think there was also the comment at one point that it could be split off as an ad hoc thing.
Right.
And I totally disagree with that as the basic premise. I think the basic premise is coordination, and then as the time gets closer, entirely split off and ad hoc, just like to work on the goals for the town council, to work on the evaluation instrument, for example. Split off an ad hoc group to work on that so that all 13 don't have to work on it, so that all five of us aren't for it. But we're coordinating the process, not doing it all ourselves.
Right. And all 13 counselors are going to be doing evaluations anyway, so.
Well, under some people's opinion, that wouldn't happen.
Oh.
So that's one of the reasons I want this body to coordinate so that we can have those discussions with whoever.
Right, no, I guess that hasn't been decided, but.
It seems obvious to some of us, but perhaps not all of us, that all 13 counselors would have some say.
Mm-hmm.
And so that doesn't mean that you couldn't have an ad hoc group of committee chairs that worked on one aspect of this, et cetera. So I move to retain the coordination of the annual review process of the town manager within the OCA charge. Alyssa moved. Who seconded?
I seconded.
I did.
Okay, Darcy seconded.
I seconded. She already
good. All right.
All right, so all those in favor?
Well, we're through discussion, I guess. Is that it?
Is there any more to be said?
I have my reservations about this. I really think that this is something I would dearly love to hand off to a group and just let them worry about it for the entire year. We have enough to do. I don't feel strongly, coordinations, but that means we're ultimately responsible for making sure that this thing gets done. And I would prefer to have another group responsible for it, and we just don't have to worry about that particular task. It's this one particular task that's done every year and has to be done in a certain way, and it should involve a certain set group of people. And if every year we have to revisit it, okay, who gets to be on it this time? And is it this committee chair or that committee chair, da, 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 da. You know, I mean, we can do it, and I guess we'll do it. But I have no problem with giving this to an ad hoc, call it what you will, but another body, of which maybe one or two of us will be members or maybe we won't. But, and that's their job and their responsibility, and they have to meet the deadlines and they have to do all the paperwork, blah, 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 blah. Because this is going to be, as you know, an enormously demanding task to be done right. So that's my only concern. I'm not going to die for it, but you know, I don't have a problem with farming this off to somebody else.
I would ask that you hold on to all those concerns,
yeah,
and as we move along, mm-hmm, that you vote for my motion. And then as we move along,
no,
that you say, now I can see where we can carve pieces off of this, where this is not going to be our responsibility, where we are just going to set up, you know, this part of it, but the rest of it is going to be retained by other people. I can tell you for a fact,
mm-hmm,
that what will happen if we don't retain some control,
mm-hmm,
of this process,
mm-hmm,
is we will have no control of this process, meaning the council will have no control of this process.
Mm-hmm.
A few individual members will have control of this process.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I want us to remain in a coordinating position,
okay,
until we get further along. And then there might very well be a structure, like a decision tree, that makes sense that people could carry forward in years subsequent. But I think largely the first year we're going to have to get through it. And then see, because you're stuck with the old stuff that the town manager is being evaluated on, select board evaluated, because you can't, you know, decide suddenly you're evaluating on other things this time. But then for that whole process to unfold, that it may well be that next year at this time, George,
mm-hmm,
we're taking ourselves out of the process because it no longer needs to be coordinated by us, in theory, or some lesser amount of it does.
Mm-hmm.
But I hear what you're saying in terms of the workload. Absolutely, but if we're assigning piece parts, I mean, I think we assign piece parts out, and that's what we can, or we ask the president to assign piece parts out to people or whatever. I just, I am loath to let go of a group that has a huge, to me, has a huge stake in the town manager evaluation based on the appointments he brings us. The rest of the council, no matter what process we decide council-wide, the rest of the council will never know the town council, the town manager's appointment process as well as we do, and how effective or not effective we perceive that to be, I think, is a huge part of his evaluation.
Mm.
So that's why I think it makes sense for us to carry it forward.
I would argue people that our workload of this committee may not be a huge.
Once we get through more of the structure,
after
we get through
June
30th,
we'll never have to come up with another decision tree. Where, as far as I can tell, for outreach, the only thing that we may do is help do forums,
yeah,
and special hearings, which I don't want to do, and I think that what Paul said is that his staff actually should,
yeah,
be doing it.
Yeah, I kind of object to the way that was talked about in our report, in that,
well,
we're not like the little sunshine club that's going and making,
no,
the forums work for people.
No, well, I was,
no,
just saying that's the,
yeah,
only thing I could possibly see, but
no,
I have an argument. All right. Like, we don't have to do it. Like,
yeah,
we don't really,
right,
have a big part in outreach. Yes.
I want you to say, I agree with a lot of what George said, especially because I personally have no interest in being involved with those. That said, I would be incredibly hesitant to remove it from our charge without seeing a
what's
going to
take its place,
what,
right,
it would be.
Right.
And it sounds like the president's argument at current is, I don't think it belongs in your committee, so take it out, and we'll figure out what it'll be like. And she has some ideas and she's expressed some of it, but it's not a fully formed proposal.
Right. No,
and so I think for now, at least, we should say this stays in our committee. If you want to bring, if someone wants to bring forward a proposal of how we could better do a town manager evaluation, then we can look at it and we could say, you know what, we will remove this.
Mm-hmm.
But to remove it from our charge,
right,
before knowing what it's going to be,
right,
seems like a, I don't want to say dangerous, but it's a weird thing to do.
I like that.
We have a motion.
Seconded.
Seconded. So, all in favor? Say
it's
aye.
All a work in progress.
All right.
Wait a minute.
It's to retain. The motion is to retain.
To retain. Okay.
To retain.
Okay.
For now.
For now.
Okay.
All right. Then, Evan has to be.
Yeah. Sorry. I gotta run.
Okay. We got it all done.
Yeah. It's because you were pushing.
I know. It looked scarier when I saw
everything.
The four votes were just described two different ways. So the four bullet points are just two
descriptions of taking it out, voting
so
on it, taking
it
out, voting. Yes, we'll work on the report.
Are you going to be around there today?
I am going to be at work, but for the next little while, I have some time, depending on what your schedule looks like.
So
are you guys
going to
go ahead? You have, you technically have a committee meeting that, and I will just put this aside. I can be a visitor at your committee if I don't talk. How's that? So that the minutes of the next, so we have to adjourn at what time? I move to adjourn.
11:17.
11:17. Thank you, Evan, for straightening us out.
I will see
on
you all
how to describe
later.
Things.
Way too soon.
Yes.
All right.
Okay, so we adjourned at 11:17, and now.